my goodness. If you thought that it was bad when you heard the story about the Silk Road trial, the behind-the-scenes ugliness in the DEA and the Secret Service, where one DEA agent, one Secret Service agent have now pled guilty to various different felony charges, essentially on corruption charges for extracting hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of Bitcoin from the Silk Road servers, basically, and doing all other manner of corrupt activities, including possibly revealing inside information about the FBI to the people that were running the Silk Road, which is an underground drug marketplace, or was an underground drug marketplace. If you thought that corruption was bad, which basically could possibly undermine the case that the government made against Silk Road founder Ross Ulbricht, sending him to prison for life, then wait till you hear what we have to tell you about tonight.
I hear it's a big deal.
Because the allegations that are coming out now are pretty shocking. And they involve kidnapping. Specifically kidnapping a lady we've had on this show before, the mother of Ross Ulbricht, Lynn Ulbricht, kidnapping her and also kidnapping his sister, Ross's sister. I don't know her name, but
people were going to kidnap Ross's family.
That is the allegation.
Okay.
So what we have to go on right now is a forum post on a website called myplanetganja.com.
This doesn't sound real firm. You got a forum post on myplanetganja.com. All right.
Yeah, and the post is made by someone who is ostensibly Variety Jones. Now,
who's Variety Jones?
People aren't going to really necessarily recall this, even if you paid close attention to the case, Variety Jones. If you paid close attention to the Silk Road case, Variety Jones was mentioned. I mean,
I remember the name.
He had a role, ostensibly, and that was basically as an advisor or a mentor to Ross Ulbricht. Now, for those that don't know, the Silk Road is what, Mark? What is the Silk Road? Or was the Silk Road?
It was an online marketplace where people could buy and sell anything.
Weapons were not allowed. Certain types of poison or child pornography was not allowed.
Sell nearly anything. Right. And it was on the dark web, so you couldn't get there from sort of like the regular internet. You had to use Tor, which anonymized everything.
That's correct.
It used Bitcoin, which anonymized everything. So it was this kind of anonymous marketplace. And as a result, people did sell a bunch of different things, but a lot of them were drugs.
Yes. And the federal government and, of course, governments from around the world took great interest in taking down the Silk Road, ultimately somehow ferreting out the location of their server. And we still don't know how they pulled that one off, because Tor is supposed to be an anonymous system.
It is the mystery.
And the court case, they never broached the subject of how they actually got to the physical location of the server in order to take a copy of the server, dig through that information, ultimately leading them to Ross Ulbricht as the purported architect of the entire operation, the man who ostensibly created the Silk Road with the help and the advice of Variety Jones. Variety Jones disappeared as of the takedown of the Silk Road. The first
seems
Silk
like
Road.
A good thing to do.
Yeah, so this was back in October of 2013 when the Silk Road was taken down. We're now 2 years, basically 2 years away from when that happened, and Variety Jones has ostensibly resurfaced. Vice.com has a story about it, and I know that the person who's posting as Variety Jones, he's posting actually under a different name on myplanetganja.com called Plural of Mongoose. And the thing with this...
What is the plural of mongoose?
That's a good question.
Mongooses? Mongeese?
Those both sound like fine guesses to me. All three of them sound like good guesses. You're welcome to share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. But thing is, this post or this account on the forum, you know, as you said, Mark, Planet Ganja doesn't exactly sound like the place you would expect to see a tell-all piece about the inside workings of FBI corruption regarding the Silk Road, but here it is nonetheless. And one of the reasons why it's
I bet they love the attention.
One of the reasons why it's here is because Plural of Mongoose, a.k.a. Variety Jones, or ostensibly Variety Jones, has had an account here for a long time. So his account was registered on this site back in May of 2009.
Okay.
So the idea is that that's some evidence that this is who he says he is, because he used this account previously, and the people on this forum know who he is. So he's like back on an old forum that he had been on in the past.
Yep.
Like, hey guys, I'm back. Here's what I've been up to for the last 2 years, which essentially is being threatened by some sort of secretive agent from the FBI. And I'll get into the details about that here in a moment. But that was my first question when I saw this post. I was actually over on the new Bitcoin.com forums is how I found out about this. Roger Ver had posted a link to this guy's post on the cannabis.
Yeah, that's how I saw it too.
And so I read through this insanely long post. It's super detailed. I don't know how many thousands of words it is, but it took me a while.
It's small book.
To read through this today. And that was just one of his posts. He's been telling a few different stories on this lengthy 11-page long thread that is only going to get longer. He said he's happy to field anyone's questions that posts them to the thread. So there are a number of questions that are being posted basically as we speak. This is breaking news. This happened earlier this morning Eastern time. So this is developing as of right now. So Plural of Mongoose, in a very, very lengthy post, basically explains that he had, for the last couple of years, been engaged in this dialogue with this undercover agent, or whatever you want to call him, not undercover, but just somebody who's supposedly in the high levels of the FBI, somebody who knows what's going to happen, someone who can feed information to people to ostensibly keep them safe from getting busted, because this FBI agent knows what's going to happen. And Variety Jones, aka Plural of Mongoose, claims that this agent told him things that were going to happen before they happened.
Okay.
So, like, that he proved himself was the idea, that, you know, this agent definitely knew some stuff that nobody else knew about, told Variety Jones this in advance of when it actually happened. So as an example, he gave Variety Jones the information about the corrupt agents, the DEA and the Secret Service agent, that have now pled guilty to various corruption-related charges.
Okay.
He ostensibly told Variety Jones about this before it happened. And so that's you know, gives the guy some credibility, right?
Well, it gives some credibility with Variety Jones. At this point,
but
I need credibility from Variety Jones.
Right. No, these are allegations,
yeah.
Okay, but
it's all very interesting.
The idea is that this is Variety Jones.
If your story weaves together nicely, then okay.
It's super detailed. I mean, obviously
it could seem to be.
It obviously could have been faked, right? And there's still, I mean, maybe there's no real proof yet that this is the guy who he claims to be, but the people on the forum seem to believe that it is him.
Okay.
He does have some PGP stuff in here as well that one could probably, if you had his PGP signature from before, could probably compare, and I suspect someone has done that.
Okay.
Vice News says that they have verified that the person behind the account is who they say they are.
Okay, that's big news.
So, you know, I'm taking this as some pretty serious allegations that, you know, if it turns out that they are true, is going to be an absolute bombshell, I think, for the Ross Ulbricht case. If it can be found out who this FBI agent is, who ultimately ends up threatening Variety Jones, threatening Ross Ulbricht's family, and all of this is over, you might be asking yourself, why is this FBI agent threatening this Variety Jones? What's this all about? So the claim is that the agent has access to Ross Ulbricht's secret wallet. That Bitcoin is this decentralized currency. For our listeners that don't know, it's not created by any government or any bank. It's it can be used anonymously, but by default, it's not necessarily anonymous. It's actually very public and traceable because every transaction is available publicly. There's a public ledger. And so the agent claims to have a wallet full of, I don't know, was it $300 million worth of Bitcoin or something?
Lots of Bitcoin.
Like that?
However, everyone knows that that's Ross Ulbricht's secret wallet, so the money has to stay in there because it's visible.
No, I don't think that everyone knows what this wallet is.
Okay.
I think that's one of the things about this wallet. And we don't know much about the wallet itself yet, but that's the claim,
right,
is that the agent has access to this wallet, but he does not have a passcode to send the Bitcoin out of the wallet. And
then
he wants to get
access?
That passcode.
How does he have access?
He wants to get that passcode. We'll explain how. It's Free Talk Live.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
Mom, you text so slow. Abbreviate. Use BTW for by the way and LOL for laugh out loud.
Well, I'm texting Dad to make a reservation at America's Best Value Inn. Got one for that?
ABVI.
ABVI?
America's Best Value Inn. Everyone knows they're BVOTR, the best value on the road.
You're right. They have free internet and continental breakfast at most of their 1,000 hotels in North America, plus instant rewards with the Value Club.
You'd better text Dad to go to ABVI.com ASAP.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from Retail Me Not right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the Retail Me Not app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit retailmenot.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this room.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait,
you go.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We're doing the live Sunday edition of the program. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here, is 855-450-FREE, talking about some not-so-shocking allegations. I mean, it's not a surprise that an FBI agent would be a corrupt killer, but those are some of the allegations that are coming out now by someone who appears to be the mentor of Ross Ulbricht. Ross is the guy who's now in prison for life for running the Silk Road, the underground drug marketplace, the most infamous of the underground drug marketplaces on
the
internet.
Why are you not surprised that an FBI agent would be some kind of crazy killer here? Yes, it's crazy that in this circumstance there was already, it was one of them was FBI.
DEA, there's one DEA and there's one Secret Service agent who have gone down now for corruption allegations. Okay. I'm just not surprised, Mark. These cops are corrupt in a lot of cases, and the more power they have at their disposal, the more likely they are to be corrupt. And
the ones are supposed to be the FBI, right? They're supposed to be the best.
Well, whatever that means, what does it mean to be the best?
I don't know what that means, precisely.
We certainly know that power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely, and somebody at the high levels of the FBI certainly has plenty of power that they can wield. And this guy seems to be a tech wizard as well. This isn't just some clunky agent with a gun running after criminals. This is a tech, you know, kind of IT agent guy who, you know, knows his stuff when it comes to the internet. So he's got, not only does he have his own personal hacking skills at his disposal, he also has whatever tools that the FBI has access to, which I suspect are probably similar to what the NSA has access to as well. So this guy has tremendous level of tools at his disposal, including the entire Justice Department. And you'll see how he wields some of those against the man who is supposed to be Variety Jones. And Vice.com says they have verified the identity, independently they claim, verified the identity of the individual behind the account that is posting some of these allegations. Now, what we don't know is who the FBI agent is yet. That information has not been revealed, and Variety Jones claims to not know. He's been trying to figure it out, but he has not been successful.
That's what he's asking for help for, right?
Well, actually, what he's looking to do now, I'm sure he would appreciate help if someone else could figure it out, but he's actually so desperate now, it seems like, that he's willing to turn himself in. He has actually contacted the FBI. He contacted the agent who is kind of running the operations for the Manhattan district of the FBI, the person who's overseeing the Ross Ulbricht case. He's sent an email, more than one, to this person, telling this person that Severin, I think is that person's name, that they're willing to turn that Variety Jones is willing to turn himself in. And he hasn't gotten an email back yet.
That's weird.
So, yeah.
You'd think that the FBI would be really excited to talk to this guy, right?
To talk to one of the founders of the Silk Road. That's who this guy is purportedly claiming to be.
I'd also be more interested if I were he and just, like, going someplace and, getting out of here.
He's already out of here. This guy is actually somewhere in, like, Cambodia or whatever.
That is actually where I was thinking.
Yeah. In fact, that's a good chunk of his story that he tells, and it's a long one. I'm not going to read it for you online, but I did link over to the Vice.com summary of it on our Facebook and Twitter, and then I think they linked to the actual post. But part of the story is that at one point, this undercover or this corrupt agent with the FBI, to prove that he's got, you know, the ability to pull strings, he puts out some sort of a be-on-the-lookout, a bolo, if you will, to international policing agencies.
Okay.
And to basically have them, if this guy tries crossing the border, detain him. Okay, so if Variety Jones tries to cross the border in whatever country he's in, take him. Is essentially the order.
Got it.
And he's, you know, in a way, I guess, wherever it is that he is staying, to where he knows some of the authorities. He got together with some of the cops in the area, and he asked them, look, is this happening? Is my name, you know, do they want me, right? And they said, well, we're not looking for you, but immigration definitely is. And so he managed to get in touch with the immigration guys, but he claims... It's just an amazing story that he writes.
Right,
here,
right? Sure.
He claims to have bought them like really fancy liquor, and then has a bunch of drinks with them and talks to them about what's happening. Is he wanted? And they show him, or he's shown at some point the wanted flyer with a terrible picture of him, and so it's real. Like according to him, that the be on the lookout.
That's gonna be a crazy thing to see of yourself, by the way.
Yeah, and so he then asks, well, what's the reward? And he said that the reward was like 20,000 of the Thai currency or whatever that is.
Baht.
And apparently it translates into like $700, so some chintzy reward.
Yeah.
So he threw down 50,000 and walked away from the table.
I'll bet.
So it's just a really kind of really freaky story. I'll give you the summary here from Vice.com. Joseph Cox writing, the man believed to be forgotten Silk Road architect Variety Jones has published a series of accusations against someone he suspects is a corrupt FBI employee guilty of crimes including leaking sensitive information to criminals, extorting the owners of dark web marketplaces for bitcoins, and even conspiracy to kidnap. The story of $75 million of pirates' treasure in bitcoins, Variety Jones wrote in a post on a cannabis enthusiast forum Sunday, that's today, under one of his pseudonyms, which is plural of mongoose. The story of a rogue, highly placed member of the FBI who's been making better than an average of $1 million per month, committing felonies with wild abandon just because he can.
If you had that kind of money, why in the world would you... I mean, just why would you get yourself, do something to get yourself caught? That kind of money, just get out of there. Retire, go.
You mean the federal agent?
Yeah.
I guess it's the power and the greed. You know, he's gotten $10 million so far, ostensibly. It's one of the claims that's made in the long version of the story. The FBI agent, you know, bragging, essentially, to Variety Jones about his prowess.
Yeah.
Claiming
and
to
how much of that is true, you don't know.
We don't. Claiming to have extracted millions already from the existing darknet marketplaces.
Right.
And one of the stories that he tells is he predicts the fall of the evolution marketplace.
Okay.
Now, let me rewind briefly here, because there's obviously a lot of context to this stuff. The evolution marketplace was the marketplace that went down, I don't know, a few months ago at this point. I think it was over the summer when it went down.
This is another one of these online drug marketplaces that I don't even remember the name of this.
Evolution Marketplace was what it was called, and it was one of the more popular ones.
Okay.
It went under all of a sudden, and the claim was, you know, the classic reason for this is, oh, well, it was a scam by the operators. The operators took everybody's money.
Yeah.
You know, so the idea
makes sense.
The idea is you get one of these darknet markets running, you're anonymous, so no one knows who the hell's operating these darknet marketplaces. So the operators are completely anonymous, and so they run this marketplace for a period of time, let's say 6 months, and it gets busy because it's working, right? The system works. People are buying and selling drugs, and you know the drugs are arriving, and the customers are satisfied, and everybody's getting paid. It looks good. And then all of a sudden, bang, marketplace disappears, and however many millions of dollars worth of Bitcoin happen to be in everyone's accounts, the thousands of accounts on the system, that's all gone. So the idea was that this was a scam by these operators. They set up the site with the intention of taking it offline after several months and running with the Bitcoin. And that makes sense.
Sounds legit, sure.
But the claim was the supposed true story, according to this FBI agent, and he predicted, according to Variety Jones, the guy writing the blog post, he predicted the fall of this particular marketplace. His claim was that he had extorted $6 million from this marketplace by hacking into the system, sitting in the back end of the system and waiting for an administrator to log in, identifying the IP address of the administrator, tracking it using his government ability to find out where the IP address is physically from,
okay,
going to that person's house with having thugs go to the person's house, hired thugs.
Where do you get thugs?
And if you've
got
the money,
I wish I knew where to get thugs.
If you've got the connections and the money, this guy would... You would believe this guy has the thugs based on what he's able to pull off.
Okay.
And then threatening the operator of that marketplace is why he pulled it offline. It's Free Talk Live.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Here's an urgent alert from the Student Loan Hotline. The average student loan debt is $25,000. Have you been out of college for 10 or more years and you're still making your student loan payments? If you are struggling with paying off your student loan, if you are past due, we can help. Nationwide Student Loan Relief can now restructure your student loans. We can get your student loans out of default, stop any wage garnishments, stop harassing collection calls, and even and eliminate your student loan payment. If you can't afford your student loans, or if you're past due and you need help, you must call right now. We will restructure your loan or your money back, and that's a guarantee. So call the Student Loan Hotline right now. 800-291-2865. 800-291-2865. 800-291-2865. 800-291-2865.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Yeah! Come on! It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. If you want to comment on the latest allegations, surprising allegations for a lot of people, I'm sure, in the Silk Road case, where there's supposedly an FBI agent who has been revealing secret FBI information to people in the darknet markets, specifically one Variety Jones, who is the mentor of the man who created the Silk Road, Ross Ulbricht, who is now in prison for the rest of his life, unless his appeal is successful, which is in the works. The appeal for Ross is still snaking its way through the so-called justice system. And, of course, we've been following this case the entire time in great detail here on Free Talk Live. So if you want to comment, please, we've got Skype open, Skype username lrn.fm, and toll-free number 855-450-FREE. Now, if you want to get some Bitcoin, because Bitcoin's useful for all kinds of stuff, like saving 20% at Amazon, for instance, or more, we'll tell you about that later on. But if you want to get some Bitcoin, get started at expresscoin.com. They will sell you Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin even. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business. You can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just get started at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can likely help you. Expresscoin.com. Do it from your smartphone. Download their app. It's expresscoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. You'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee at all when you do it through expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. So more here from the MyPlanetGanja.com post from Variety Jones, a.k.a. Plural of Mongoose. His real name is ostensibly Thomas Clark.
Now,
Roger Thomas Clark.
I'm told on the internet that it's PGP or it didn't happen, is the reality here. And supposedly he posted his PGP's, stuff, and he has been verified by which magazine?
Vice magazine. Yeah. That's right. And so going on here with the Vice story, which kind of summarizes what is, I don't know how many thousands of words, this very, very detailed post where this gentleman is telling his story about what he's been doing for the last 2 years, because he disappeared. As soon as the Silk Road was taken down, or right around the same time, he went underground. And so now he has risen, shall we say. He is being seen on this old forum that he used to hang out on some time ago. So he says it's a story of a bent federale who's leaked me secret grand jury information in an effort to keep me out of the hands of his colleagues. Variety Jones, that's the man writing the long story here, claims that an anonymous source contacted him months after the Silk Road was shut down, offering inside information. The anonymous source, who later called himself Diamond, claimed to be an FBI agent and said he could provide tips about investigations into dark web marketplaces. He claimed to have provided such information to Atlantis, the dark web drug site that would eventually shut down in 2013, according to Variety Jones. I don't know if you remember Atlantis, but they...
Yeah, I remember that one.
They were the first one to kind of make a splash as competing with the Silk Road, and they didn't make it for very long. They were only up for a few months before they shut down. If I recall correctly, Diamond made good on his promise of information, said Variety Jones, by tipping him off ahead of time about the investigations into Karl Marx Force IV and Sean Bridges, two law enforcement officials who stole funds from the Silk Road. And as we mentioned earlier, those two men, Karl Force and Sean Bridges, DEA agent and Secret Service agent respectively, they have pled guilty to those corruption charges. So those cases are closed at this point.
Yeah.
But the thing was, with those two, with the DEA and the Secret Service agent, those corruption charges, they were held back from being revealed during the trial. So Ross Ulbricht and his attorneys knew about this. They knew about these allegations against these agents, the corruption allegations, but they were prohibited from talking about them during the trial. And so now that those guys have been caught on corruption charges, that could be another basis for the appeal. Basically, hey, look, the evidence that you guys used to convict our client was collected in part by these two guys who have now pled guilty to corruption.
Yeah.
So go ahead and strike all that evidence.
They should.
Yeah. I think that's going to be the plan. Whether that'll work or not in court is another question.
Well, it's hard to consider the evidence collected by two agents that have, used their position to steal millions of dollars as particularly good evidence.
I agree. So that's why I'm saying
I hope
that works.
We exist in a world, in a governmental setup where the idea is that it is better that 10 guilty men go free than that one innocent be convicted. That's the idea. Now, the average person out there in America seems to just not care if innocent people are in prison. That's going to happen. That's the idea, and that's the way the judicial system's supposed to work.
Well, we know how it's supposed to work, and we know that this judge had it out for Ross Ulbricht.
Oh, it was obvious, it seemed to me.
She was doing some terrible things that she should not have been able to do. But that as an aside. So going on here, the undercover, this agent, the secret agent that nobody knows who it is with the FBI, tells Variety Jones about the investigations into these two corrupt cops, the DEA and the Secret Service. And this and other inside information convinced Variety Jones that Diamond was, in fact, an FBI agent, because no one else could have known at the time at which this agent was telling Variety Jones about it. The news had not broken publicly at all about these two men being investigated. Diamond also claimed to be doing a robust business and reaping bitcoins by trading in information and blackmailing dark web marketplace owners. Diamond informed Variety Jones about the imminent closure of the Evolution marketplace in mid-March, allegedly because of an extortion campaign that Diamond carried out against the marketplace. So this guy claims that the entire Evolution marketplace shut down because of him, this Diamond character, this FBI agent.
That's crazy.
That he essentially hacked into their system. This is what they don't go into here in the Vice article. The detail is he hacked into their system, supposedly, and then sat there and watched the logs and watched for one of the admins to come in, went to the admin's house, basically. I don't think he did it. He might have hired someone to do it.
But he got the IP for them.
Yeah, got their IP address, tracked down their physical location, went there and literally threatened their life over $6 million. If you don't pay me $6 million, I'll kill you. And so the dude shut down the Evolution Marketplace, raided everyone's accounts, and then handed it over to this undercover agent. So crazy, just crazy allegations here going on. Diamond also claimed to be in possession of a Bitcoin wallet. And this is the real crux of the story. This is why he's contacting Variety Jones.
Right.
He has a Bitcoin wallet containing over 300,000 Bitcoin. So I was wrong. I said $300 million worth. That's about $70 million worth at today's exchange rates.
I can see why you might want to do. Somebody could die over $70 million.
That previously belonged to Ross Ulbricht, says the FBI agent.
He can't use it now.
The convicted creator of the Silk Road. The wallet is protected
by... So this FBI agent wants to make sure that Ross's mother, Lynn, gets the money.
No, he wants the $70 million for himself.
He's going to steal it. All
but
right.
He claims he's willing to split it with Variety Jones if Variety Jones helps him get into the wallet.
Okay.
The idea is that Variety might, as the mentor, as the person who was, you know, close buddies online with Ross Ulbricht, might be able to help him get into this this wallet.
Okay.
And of course, as Variety Jones points out in his exposed, you know, his tell-all post, it's like, well, of course he's willing to claim he's going to give me all these millions of dollars, but it wouldn't be hard to bump me off afterward anyway, right? So he's not willing to help him with this particular plan. Anyway, so he claims to have this wallet, but it's protected by a password. And Diamond believes that Variety could help him access, or could maybe he even knows the password, or could help him access the funds in the wallet. He wants me to move to Singapore, says Variety Jones, where he can set up a safe house and know that I am clear from the clutches of the Department of Justice.
Somebody will kill you there.
He also says, exactly, that Diamond warned of an Interpol red notice against him and that immigration police were hunting him in Thailand, where he had been living. Earlier this month, Motherboard published an extensive investigation into the identity of Variety Jones based on the previous work of an independent researcher, La Moustache. Variety Jones made financial and security decisions around the Silk Road and was referred to Ross Ulbricht as a mentor. Motherboard named Variety Jones as Roger or Thomas Clark, a Canadian man in his 50s, and tracked him down to the Thai island of Koh Chang. According to his blog post, Variety Jones, a.k.a. Thomas Clark, told Diamond he wanted nothing to do with breaking into the Bitcoin wallet, and that's when Diamond allegedly started making threats and brought Ross Ulbricht's sister and his mother into these threats, including kidnapping and torture. It's Free Talk Live.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We are Free Talk Live. You can join the show here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the latest developments in the Silk Road case, which no one saw this coming. Variety Jones.
I certainly didn't.
the mentor of Ross Ulbricht, the guy who is now in prison for life for running the Silk Road, the infamous underground drug marketplace taken down by the feds in 2013, Variety Jones, who disappeared in 2013, is back, and it appears that it's him.
It's been checked out through
Vice.com, checked it out, and all the people on this forum, the My Planet Ganja, where he's posting his tell-all about what's been going on in the last couple of years, they seem to believe that it is indeed him. So I'm taking that as legit. And the allegations that he is revealing are pretty amazing regarding one particular agent within the FBI who's super corrupt and super dangerous, has a lot of access to very privileged information, and has shared that information, allegedly, these are all allegations, with Variety Jones, a.k.a., what was it, Thomas Clark, I think it was his real name? Yeah, Thomas Clark, Roger Thomas Clark, he goes by Thomas. And so we've been sharing with you the motherboard.com or .vice.com, motherboard.vice.com summary of what is probably a multiple thousand word post that Variety Jones has made on the My Planet Ganja forums. I linked to the motherboard article on our Facebook and Twitter. I'll put the link directly to the bitcoin.com thread where we're talking about this stuff. It's pretty amazing. Let's see, where did I leave off here? Thomas Clark, the threats. Right, so we're going to get to the threats. And what is happening, or allegedly happening, to this Variety Jones is that because he was one of the originators of the Silk Road, he was close to Ross Ulbricht, this FBI agent...
This rogue FBI agent.
Right, believes that
Variety Jones might be able to help him get into a wallet, a Bitcoin wallet, that has something like 300,000 Bitcoin in it. That's
nearly
70 million.
I don't know why he believes
million.
That, right? Like, you know, I know you and I've worked with you for 12 years. I wouldn't call me your mentor, but we're business partners, mm-hmm. and I don't know what the password is to your Bitcoin wallet.
Right. That's right.
I mean, it's an odd thing to believe that a business partner might know. But then again, if it's all you got, it's all you got, right?
Yeah, it's all he's got besides a kidnapping plot, which he reveals later on. And we'll get to that. So he started making threats. Variety Jones wrote in, and this is again from the Vice.com summary, quote, "If I ever effed up and fell into the hands of the feds, he had the reach and knew the people and most importantly had the funds to have me killed," he wrote. After this, Diamond, who's the FBI agent, supposedly made an extraordinary claim that he would kidnap Ross Ulbricht's sister or mother, or ideally both, get a video-capable phone in front of Ross Ulbricht, and he'd give up that effing passphrase, and Diamond would have them tortured until he did, according to Variety Jones. And if for a moment you don't think that you can get a smartphone to a prisoner in jail, you are totally wrong about
that.
Well,
yeah, we have prisoners call the show and say that they've that they've seen that situation.
Yeah, exactly. Variety Jones provided a torture.
And this is $70 million, people. This isn't the kind of thing where you're just like, oh, you know, that would be kind of hard. Let's just forget about it.
Well, right. $70 million is what he's after if he could get into that wallet. And he already claims to have extorted something like $10 million from the existing darknet marketplaces. Variety Jones provided a Tor chat ID for Diamond in his forum post. Although the ID is active, whoever is behind it did not immediately respond to messages. Variety Jones claims he contacted Assistant U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of New York, Saren Turner, who prosecuted Ross Ulbricht, to warn him of the actions of Mr. Diamond. Under the circumstances, quote, "I am very concerned about falling into the clutches of Diamond or subjecting myself to custody of the U.S. justice system where, considering the money involved, I would be in fear for my life," unquote. Variety Jones wrote in an email supposedly dated May of 2015 and included in his forum post. So this is the email that he sends to this Severin guy.
The Severin guy? You mean Saren, agent, special agent Saren?
Saren Turner.
That is supposed to be working for the government and would want very much, supposedly, to get a hold of Variety Jones and would obviously want to stop a rogue agent inside their organization that he didn't get back to him?
Yeah, he has not written him back at all, and he wrote a follow-up email later, and still the guy, this federal agent, has not gotten back to him.
This dude can't get arrested.
That's correct.
That's crazy.
At this point, there's no way to independently verify Clark's claims, but aka Variety Jones, but Motherboard has independently confirmed the identity of the individual behind the account. Turner did not immediately respond to Motherboard's request for comment. That's Turner's the FBI agent, and neither did the FBI. So as of right now, the only person talking is Variety Jones, and the Ganja thread, the MyPlanetGanja.com thread, continues on right now. He's actually answering questions here this evening. So anybody that has questions for him can go on this thread, register for an account on the forums, and post their questions.
So dude's in Cambodia right now?
Purportedly he's in Thailand.
Okay.
But maybe he's already moved from Thailand. I don't know. He knows that the...
I wouldn't want people to know where it was if it was just a circumstance.
To the absolute best of my... Well, what he says is anybody... He, in his long... Again, his post is really long. We just shared with you a very brief summary from Vice.com. In his post, he talks about moving from the beach into the woods, basically, in Thailand, and says that anybody who put 90 minutes in could probably figure out where he was. So, you know, the federal government doesn't exactly reach into the woods of Thailand, and so they're not going to be able to go and get him. But he also says in a later post that there's no net closing around him, that they don't want to bring him in. That's one of the reasons why they're not responding to his emails at this point. But he adds here in one of his posts that went up this evening, and this is just sort of as an aside, "To the absolute best of my knowledge, Mr. Mark Karpeles had absolutely zero involvement in the Silk Road website." Now, Mark Karpeles is the guy who founded MT Gox.
He was sort of the second suspect, another suspect in this.
He was talked about in the Silk Road case when Ross was being prosecuted as a possible alternate Dread Pirate Roberts, an alternate operator of the website. This is the guy who was running MT Gox, which is the world's, for a while, most popular Bitcoin exchange, which went under.
And he'll be spending his own time in jail soon.
He is definitely being charged with various different financial-related crimes. And so Variety Jones says that he was not involved in the Silk Road website in any way, shape, or form. That said, Silk Road wasn't the only darknet market out there. Now, was it? Even if the feds seem to have forgotten that when they cleared him of Silk Road involvement. Stay tuned for more on that from Japan, I'm thinking. The authorities there are sitting on terabytes of interesting data. So we certainly have not heard the end of the Mark Karpeles story. But just to go back to the most important element of this story, the most outrageous and shocking portion of it, the kidnapping allegations. So this guy, this FBI agent claims that, look, Variety Jones, right, if you don't help me get into this wallet, I'm going to kidnap people and torture them.
Well, he's saying that he's going to get that money out of that wallet. And
right.
The Variety Jones has the option of, A, helping him, which likely Variety Jones quite possibly doesn't have the information to be able to help with. I mean, you know, this is like I'd said earlier even, Ian, I don't know what, say, the PIN number is on your debit card
right.
or something like that. And we're business partners and have worked together for 12 years.
Yeah, why Ross Ulbricht would have given this man access, who he did not know.
Right, you
know,
they $70 million.
Right, they were online business partners, and they never knew who they, you know, each other were necessarily.
However, you know, I can see why this guy might want that, because he doesn't want to do the, you know, the much harder work of kidnapping and torturing people.
Yeah.
So this guy, this rogue agent, who apparently has made many millions of dollars, you know, taking down other websites, that's the claim, and there's evidence for it, according to at least Variety Jones. And the claim is that Variety Jones wants to turn himself into the FBI. So, you know, it's all looking pretty legit here, that this guy, you know, might very well go and do this for $70 million. If he kidnaps somebody, and in this case, Lynn Ulbricht and Russ Ulbricht's sister,
right.
And, you know, gets a little torture going on a live stream to an Android phone that he sneaks into wherever Ross is, bet you Ross comes up with that password pretty quick.
Yes.
And I think he's probably right.
Now, the time frame on this, you may be asking yourself, well, you know, if he was going to do this, why hasn't it happened yet? The idea was that Ross is still sort of in the transitory period, right?
Yeah,
like he just received sentencing in May. He's being held in some sort of facility, and with the Federal Bureau of Prisons, it may take at least 6 months before you end up in your final facility, if you will. And even then, they could still move you around, which is what they did with Mark Emery. They moved him around, but the idea would be that he'd be more stationary after 6 months. So if you're going to get him this smartphone that he would need to find out, you know, to verify that his mother has indeed been kidnapped, then you would want him to be in a place in which he's likely going to be there. You can count that he's going to be there, etc. So that was why it was going to be toward the end of this year when the kidnapping plot was supposed to move forward if Variety Jones wouldn't help this guy out. Variety made it sound like he was willing to help, but let's just wait till the end of the year because we've got to talk to Ross at a time at which he's vulnerable. And the idea was that he'd be more vulnerable during the holiday season. So that's what they were waiting for. 855-450-FREE is our number. It's Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
What if you could look back over 150 years to find the actual addresses of your ancestors? Only at TryAncestry.com now through Sunday, you can have access to over 1 billion records in their city directory collection. Trace family members' births, deaths, addresses from historical maps, church affiliations, and more. These city directories haven't been open to the public for free access before, so don't miss this opportunity. Free access ends Sunday and is only at TryAncestry.com. That's TryAncestry.com.
SWCPoker.eu is Bitcoin Poker 2.0, where players can buy chips, play, and cash out anonymously with Bitcoin. No banking, just Bitcoin. Texas Hold'em, Omaha Hold'em, draw, and many new games, including Chinese poker. SWC Poker gladly accepts players worldwide, and over 2 million hands of Bitcoin Poker have been dealt at SWCPoker.eu. Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, SWCPoker.eu.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, September 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports the Kurdistan Workers Party, PKK, issued a statement on Friday claiming that multiple ambush attacks against the Turkish military has left 19 security forces dead, including 16 soldiers and 3 members of the National Police Force. These attacks were carried out over the course of the last couple of days and sparked another round of Turkish military retaliation, mostly in the form of airstrikes, with the military issuing a statement saying that 34 PKK fighters were killed in its attacks. The incidents took place along the Turkish border with Iraq. Turkey's southeast is predominantly Kurdish, and the PKK is active both there and in northern Iraq, which has also been the target of multiple airstrikes. Kurdish Member of Parliament Salma Armak reported that PKK leader Abdullah Öcalan, still in Turkish prison, has reiterated his support for a return to the 2-year ceasefire that was in place before Turkey launched airstrikes against the group late in July. Turkey has suggested that they have no intention to return to a ceasefire without a unilateral disarmament of the entire PKK and the group relocating wholly to Iraq. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Swiss authorities have banned the sale of Volkswagen diesel engine cars that may have been fitted with emission testing cheating devices. The move, seen as temporary, puts a stop to the sale of some 180,000 Volkswagen models not yet sold or registered in the country, and comes after the company was accused of using software to doctor emission testing results. Thomas Rohrbach, spokesman for the Swiss Federal Office of Roadways, said the ban was being implemented on Volkswagen vehicles with diesel engines in the Euro 5 emissions category. The ban does not apply to cars with Euro 6 engines, which are able to meet tougher emission standards set by the European Union. The move comes after the United States Environmental Protection Agency recalled 482,000 diesel-powered Volkswagens that had apparent defeat device software to allow the vehicles to cheat emissions tests. Since diesel vehicles are more popular in Europe, Volkswagen is receiving far more scrutiny there. Earlier in the week, Volkswagen chief Martin Winterkorn resigned. Matthias Mueller, the former head of Porsche, has been named the Volkswagen chief executive. Mueller said, "My most urgent task is to win back the trust of the Volkswagen group by leaving no stone unturned and with maximum transparency, as well as drawing the right conclusions from the current situation."
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports separatist parties are expected to win control of Catalonia's parliament in an election on Sunday, setting the region on course for a unilateral declaration of independence from Spain, which the central government says is impossible. Opinion polls indicate the main secessionist platform, Together for Yes, and leftist party CUP are likely to fall short of 50% of the vote, but they will still secure a majority of seats in the 135-strong regional assembly. Both have said that such a result would allow them to unilaterally unilaterally declare independence within 18 months. The Spanish center-right government of Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy, which has opposed any attempt to hold a referendum on secession, has called the breakaway plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. While a breakaway by the wealthy northeastern autonomous region is still very much seen as a theoretical question, even in Catalonia, analysts say the election result will bear long-lasting consequences at local and countrywide levels. The secessionist campaign is facing a defining moment as support for the cause has steadily waned since its peak in 2013. Any failure to achieve a majority of seats would deal a serious blow to the movement. The vote may also act as a catalyst for the Spanish general election due in December. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Facing mounting criticism that lethal injection is cruel and outdated, Ohio has replaced it with a system that quickly and humanely rips off the heads of death row inmates using powerful robotic arms. The new device is designed to be as humane as possible, emitting soothing white noise and putting prisoners on a cushioned seat before its metallic talons dig into their necks and painlessly wrench their heads off. Ohio Department of Corrections Director Gary Moore praised the machine, saying, quote, "Our new system is a hallmark of compassion. Now these deaths will be pain-free because the machine's claws are coated with topical anesthetic. Quickly pulling off a prisoner's head is considered less cruel than lethal injection, which requires three separate chemicals. And Ohio isn't the only state changing the way it handles capital punishment. Last month, Texas unveiled the Machinator, which humanely squishes up to 50 prisoners at once. Coming up next, is anything valuable buried in the woods behind my house? Our team of investigators finds out.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, you're still welcome to comment on the latest Silk Road allegations that shouldn't be too shocking to anybody who has been paying close attention to the case. You know that there was already corruption that had been unveiled regarding the agents that were involved in investigating the Silk Road, the infamous underground marketplace. Well, now more corruption allegations have risen to the surface, including an alleged kidnapping plot against Ross Ulbricht's mom and his sister. If you want to join us here, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we do have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. I think I pretty much in the first hour of the show gave you the real, at least the most important details of what is a very detailed recounting of a story posted by Variety Jones, one of the site's founders.
If you want to get that, the archive of the show will be available probably, say, midnight Eastern time.
That is if the world still exists at that time, Mark. Apparently, there's a blood moon tonight, and some in the Mormon church and other religions are freaking out over this.
You know, after Y2K, I've just decided I just don't care anymore. Hmm. What crazy people talk about, the world ending and stuff like that. I mean, on Free Talk Live, I have to capitulate to some extent, right? For 3 hours a night, I'm available to talk to anyone who calls in, and that includes people that believe that the world is going to end because there's some indication here or there or the other place. But I just won't have that conversation. I won't entertain it in my mind for long. It's not going to pick up. It's not going to rent space in my mind. No thanks.
So I've got a story here from The Guardian, and there's also another one on The Blaze, which is talking about some of the people who believe that this blood moon, which is just, you know, a scientific phenomena, is going to portend some sort of disaster for the world. From TheGuardian.com, sales are up at emergency preparedness retailers ahead of a combination of a lunar eclipse and a supermoon, but the church says not to get carried away. So this is not an official proclamation by the Mormon Church. Uh-huh. There are just certain Mormons who are making a big bunch of noise about this. A rare confluence of a lunar eclipse and a supermoon happening this weekend. In fact, it's happening this evening. Has prompted such widespread fear of an impending apocalypse that the Mormon Church was compelled to issue a statement cautioning the faithful to not get caught up in speculation about a major calamity. Sunday night's blood moon and recent natural disasters and political unrest around the world have led to a rise in sales at emergency preparedness retailers.
Well, Mormons are big into the emergency preparedness thing anyway.
It's part of their religion.
It's part of their religion to be prepared for that stuff. So I don't know what that means and what people imagine is going to happen because there's a lunar eclipse that's a little closer to the Earth than
normal.
Well,
apocalyptic statements by a Mormon author have only heightened fears among a small number of Mormon followers about the looming end of time. The eclipse will give the moon a red tint.
I just feel cheated that I didn't hear about this sooner, because really what's great about the end of the world claims is the ramp up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the amount of time it's going to take to get here or whatever. And I'd like to encourage anybody who believes the world's going to end tonight, who has Bitcoin, to go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com and just unload them right now.
That'd be great. I highly doubt there's a lot of crossover in those Venn diagrams as far as like people who have Bitcoin, people who believe the world is going to end tonight. I suspect that, you know, there's not a whole lot of crossover.
There's probably some of them that have something in their PayPal account. So they can go to amp.freetalklive.com,
yeah.
Go to the one-time contribution
sure.
tab and just go ahead and empty out that PayPal account, because it's annoying. It's annoying to have money there.
We can
when
help
the world
you.
Ends.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah. Thank you for that. That's a great idea, Mark. Thank you. Amp.freetalklive.com. So the eclipse will give the moon a red tint. We did check a moment ago, and it looks normal at this
Still
point.
Still a sort of off-white, bright off-white moon.
Now, you said that you'd heard two things, that one that it was going to happen in this hour and another that it was going to happen in the 10 o'clock hour. Were you able to confirm, and we're talking about Eastern time, by the way, were you able to confirm anything further on that?
I didn't look it up.
Okay,
I'm
sorry, I thought you had done that. And maybe it was Renee who was in here from Seditious Siren. She was saying it was going to be after 10 o'clock. Anyway.
I can tell you it's this evening.
It's an event that will not happen again for 18 years. It's unclear how many members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints buy.
41 seconds is the claim.
That's how long it's going to last?
That's how long it's till it begins.
Meaning it's going to begin 41 seconds from now?
26 seconds, excuse me.
Wow, okay.
It's counting down is the claim.
Oh, that's cool. So anyway, it's unclear how many members of the church are buying into this theory, but Mormon leaders were worried enough that they took the rare step this week of issuing a public statement, cautioning the faithful to not get carried away with visions of the apocalypse. Leaders of the church told its 15 million
this
worldwide members.
This happens all the time with different religions and that sort of thing.
Disclaimers?
Yeah. No, just not the disclaimers. The disclaimers rather unusual, but religions will get wrapped up, the end times, whatever
the end times
it might be.
Rhetoric.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. Is this supposed to be part of that? The moon, I think the moon's supposed to turn to blood. Maybe that's something I've heard at some point. I just care so little because I know it's not going to happen.
They told their 15 million worldwide members they should be, quote, spiritually and physically prepared for life's up and downs, but encouraged them not to take speculation from individual church members as doctrine and to, quote, avoid being caught up in extreme efforts to anticipate catastrophic events. Sounds like okay advice.
Yeah, that's good advice.
The Mormons prepare to hunker down on Sunday night, or preparing rather to hunker down Sunday night, are not alone. Some from other religions also fear a doomsday scenario. A Christian pastor in Texas has written a book predicting a world-shaking event. Storing, and we'll talk about one of those Christian
that's
pastors
what we need to do. Yeah,
here in a moment. Storing away.
You can't sell a book by saying everything's going to
be
fine for the next month and a half.
Storing away enough food and water in case of disaster, job loss, or something worse is part of the fundamental teachings of the Mormon religion. Many homes in Utah are equipped with special shelving for cans of beans, rice, and wheat. The belief that regular history will someday end, bringing a second coming of Jesus, is embedded in the minds of Mormons and the church's official name. Though most Latter-day Saints probably haven't ever heard of this latest theory tied to the Blood Moon, the church's decision to address it publicly is significant and shows that leaders felt the need to reassert their authority on the matter. According to a chair of Mormon studies at Claremont Graduate University in California, Patrick Mason, he writes, for it to filter up to that level and for them to decide to send out a policy letter means they felt there was something they needed to tamp down on, unquote. Spokesperson for Utah-based Emergency Essentials says his company has seen a steady rise in business since June, with sales up 200% to 300%. He attributes it to a variety of events leading to more anxiety, including an earthquake in Nepal.
That's what we need to do here on Free Talk Live. We need to predict the end of the earth or the end of something, I'm not sure exactly what, and get revenue up here 200% or 300%. That would be really awesome.
Yeah, but then your prediction's not going to come true, and then you'll lose your credibility.
Neither is this one.
Yeah, and this is like not the Mormon church. This is just some Mormon guy.
Maybe we could get on a co-host that'll make the prediction, and we can just kind of play it up. And then when it doesn't happen, we kick him off.
Boom off the show. No, I don't think so. We don't do that kind of stuff here on Free Talk Live.
No.
I don't even like it when you predict what's going to happen to Bitcoin, Mark. That makes me uncomfortable, and I don't like it.
I've been wrong a few times at this point.
Yeah, Mark is not a Bitcoin expert, and neither is anyone else, by the way. They don't know what the hell's going to happen. To Bitcoin. If somebody tells you they know what's going to happen with Bitcoin tomorrow, they have no idea what they're saying.
Yeah, I had a couple of trades that I missed by about $2 or $3 and didn't work out very well for me. So, you never know.
So the guy who's running Emergency Essentials says that he believes it's the earthquake in Nepal, Russia's intervention in the Ukraine, and economic concerns in Greece and China. He said it goes well beyond the Mormons in Utah, and the company does most of its sales online with customers outside of Utah. The public pronouncement by the church comes after leaders earlier this month sent a memo to teachers in the church's religious education system for high schools and colleges, telling them to be wary of Mormon author Julie Rowe's books. This is the lady who's making the predictions. Julie Rowe writes about and speaks to audiences about her near-death experience in 2004, and she says, "The time has come" on her website. It is believed that her teachings have fueled some of the speculation. But she's not the only one. And maybe you're one of these Blood Moon believers. Are you preparing for the end?
Well, I need to hear more about it.
Our toll-free number.
At this point, I'm highly skeptical.
Is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And again, if you really, truly believe it, head on over to amp.freetalklive.com and send us the contents of your PayPal account. We will take care of it for you in your afterlife. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Are you somebody who believes that the blood moon, as it is called, which from what I understand, that's not even a scientific term for this, but the blood moon tonight is...
This is a lunar eclipse.
Right, is going to portend the end of the world. Oh, hey, that's the live stream from space.com. The space.com site claims that the webcast, which they're showing a live shot of the moon here, started at 8 p.m. Eastern. The start of the umbral eclipse portion of this is expected in about 46 minutes. So just after the 9 o'clock hour Eastern time is when the eclipse is supposed to begin, I suppose. And we've been talking about this blood moon thing. We'll get to your calls here in a moment. I want to let you know about the Bitcoin Investor Conference. It's coming up October 29th and 30th, presuming that this isn't our last show due to the end of the world. Mark, you will be in Las Vegas.
I'm counting on it, buddy.
At the D Hotel in Vegas, where they do take Bitcoin, by the way. And it's going to be the first ever Bitcoin Investor Conference. It's happening again at the D Hotel, October 29th and 30th. You will be there, Mark, broadcasting live with Free Talk Live. Plenty of other great guest speakers will be there, including Joseph von Perling, Paul Pui, Tone Vase, Bitcoin Bell, Stephen Michaels, Edmund C. May. I can't read your writing here, Mark. Edmund C. May and Trace Mayer and more, including our friend Stephanie Murphy and Brian Sovereign. Go to bitcoininvestor.com to get your tickets right now. It's an event you won't want to miss. First one ever at the D Hotel in Vegas, October 29th and 30th. Go to bitcoininvestor.com. Let's go to Ricky listening in Ohio. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Ricky.
Hello.
Hey, you're on the air.
I'm not in Ohio. I'm in Columbia, South Carolina.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Go ahead, Ricky.
Yeah, I'm with Doomsday Preppers of South Carolina. I run a Facebook page, and we've been talking about this blood moon today.
Right.
Just wanted to let you know that all of us preppers aren't crazy.
Of the preppers are crazy?
You can't really prepare for the end of the world,
can absolutely. You? Absolutely. You're exactly right. No, you're exactly right. You cannot. And we don't prepare for, like you said, there's nothing you can do about the end of the world. But that's not what all of us are focused on.
I wouldn't think they are. I mean, preppers are preparing for something, so preppers, by their very definition, must be preparing something that you can prepare for.
For unemployment, a flood, a tornado, help your neighbor out.
Those things are inevitabilities.
Absolutely. That's the reason why we prep, to be prepared.
Oh, I wouldn't indict anybody for being a prepper. I mean, I think that I've got some canned food myself.
Yeah, I consider myself sort of a mild prepper. I don't. I'm skeptical of anybody who claims to know what is going to happen. However, I think it's fair to say that something is going to happen that is going to be negative in the future.
It's not only about that; it's about getting out of debt. I mean, we don't focus.
That sounds important.
Yeah, right. We don't, you know, a lot of people think you're preppers. Oh, you guys run around the woods with a bunch of guns, and we're not like that at all.
Well, if you don't run around the woods with a bunch of guns, what the heck? This doesn't sound like you're any fun at all.
Oh, well, I got a closet full of them now. I got I got a closet full of them. Don't get me wrong. I carry also. I got my concealed weapons permit. But we're more focused on family, helping your neighbors out. So it's not all of us preppers aren't crazy. Matter of fact, I'm outside right now, and I don't see nothing going on. So I think I'm on. Nothing's going to happen tonight. So
you don't think we said that preppers were crazy. We did not say that tonight, right?
I know a lot of people do that.
Okay, you're just letting people
know. I know a lot of people do.
Gotcha.
Yeah, a lot of people do. But we're not all crazy. We're just, there's nothing wrong with being prepared.
Thank you, Ricky. I agree with that. I appreciate your call tonight. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. I think you can go overboard with the preparation.
Yeah, at some point it becomes almost pathological if you're just preparing and that sort of thing.
I think you have to draw the line between preparation and hoarding.
Yeah, yeah. I'm with you on that. I think that I wouldn't let it eat up my mind, I'm constantly worrying about whatever is going to happen in the future. I wouldn't want to live that way, but I don't think it's a bad idea to have a certain level of preparation. I mean, I own tools for a reason, because I think things are going to break.
That's pretty much a guarantee.
I can look through my life, and there's been economic upturns, economic downturns. There's been times things work, times things don't work. It seems reasonable to sort of be prepared for some things. I don't know what you need to be prepared for. That's some question you have to answer for yourself. But I've got some food put away. I've got some wells at my house that I can operate, hand crank.
I'm a terrible prepper. I mean, I do have some.
Got you, buddy.
Yeah, I do have some of the canned food, but I haven't really rotated it. So it's pretty much expired at this point, all the canned food.
Well, there's other types of food that you can have on site. I mean, that's an option.
That's true. And I have heard that the canned food lasts a lot longer in theory than the actual expiration date does. It just probably won't taste that great, and not that it tasted great in the first place.
It was canned food.
Right. So the Mormons, some of the Mormons are kind of freaked out about this, but it's not just them. There's a story over at theblaze.com. That is asking, is the coming blood moon a biblical sign from God that something earth-shattering is about to happen
when
to
you say
Israel?
Some of the Mormons are freaked out, and then you mentioned the Blaze. Do you know who runs the Blaze?
Yes, it is Glenn Beck.
Do you know what religion Glenn Beck is?
He is a Mormon.
Okay, great.
But that doesn't necessarily mean that that's what this story is about. This story is about a Texas pastor named John Hagee. You ever heard of him?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is he a Mormon?
I don't think so. No,
he's a senior pastor of the Cornerstone Church.
Yeah, that sounds right.
And he is one of the major Blood Moon pulpit pounders here, and that's what this story is focusing on.
Okay.
The Sunday night.
Well, you gotta take your opportunities where they present themselves. Never let a good crisis go unpreached.
The Sunday night will mark the fourth and final Blood Moon in a series of four total lunar eclipses over the past 2 years that some Bible experts view as prophetic signs from God. The theological proposals behind the blood moon phenomenon are nothing new, having gained support and attracted debate over the years. The notion is based on the idea that a tetrad,
I'm not sure what that is,
a rare series of four total lunar eclipses that occur over two-year periods, could indicate that something profound is about to happen involving the state of Israel.
Okay.
So, for some reason, the state of Israel is involved in this. Texas pastor John Hagee says, God is trying to tell us something.
Well, hold on. I hate this crap. Okay, first off, is God my loving and just father?
According to the Christians, yes.
Why would my loving and just father confuse me with a bunch of,
cryptic messages?
Highly cryptic messages. I mean, if I were to teach my son in this manner, people would think I was a crazy person. But God can be, if God in fact wants to give me a message, then he can give me a message easily. He could just give it to me. He could sort of speak it in my ear. Mark, this is God. You better watch out for
a blood moon.
The blood moon's a message itself. What? I don't know. The nation of Israel is going to have some upset. And I'd say, God, I don't care. So, I don't know.
Toll-free number. We'll talk more about what Hagee has to say here. Maybe will he tell us what God is trying to tell us?
Of course
I doubt it. 855-450-FREE.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's the Blood Moon edition of Free Talk Live. The toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It's certainly not the position of the hosts on the show that the world will be ending tonight, but there are people out there who believe that it is, including some Mormons and also some Christians. There's a story over at The Blaze talking about this with Pastor John Hagee, who claims he is the advocate of a theory about these four blood moons, that something is about to change, which is the name of his book, Four Blood Moons.
Yes, buy it now.
Something is about to change.
He'd be giving it away for free if he believed that the world was about to end.
Yeah. I suspect he's not giving it away for free. We'll tell you more about the story here in a moment. I also want you to know about freetalklive.com, where you can enjoy all the features totally free, and something that's not quite free, but it's getting you closer to free, is saveitpurse.com. 20% closer to free, because you can get 20% off. That's the average discount for the United States. 20% off whatever you want to buy from Amazon. Pretty much anything that's like fulfilled by Amazon, the stuff that's the free Super Saver shipping, the Amazon Prime,
yeah,
that'll all work with saveatpurse.com. So whatever you're going to want to buy on Amazon, you're going to buy it anyway. Why not take 20% off of that? Well, here's why not. You don't have Bitcoin yet. If you do have Bitcoin, then you're all set to go. Go to saveitpurse.com and get started right now and order whatever you want. If you don't yet have Bitcoin, then go to saveitpurse.com. Watch the video. Learn how this works. It's super easy.
It is.
And you go through the process. Get signed up. When you use saveitpurse.com, it takes you to our affiliate link. So Free Talk Live will get a very small portion of your future purchases through saveitpurse.com. But you don't need Bitcoin to go and get signed up for an account. So do that right now at saveitpurse.com. Then go to expresscoin.com, get your Bitcoin loaded up, and then load up your saveitpurse.com wallet and start buying stuff on Amazon at huge discounts. My last purchase, 40% off of a Blu-ray. 29% off the pair of headphones that I am wearing right now. Some of the microphone cables I'll be using at Keenvention, 20% off.
So you get pretty much everything, many things in your life that are sort of non-food. Have you tried getting some food stuff through Save
No,
Purse?
No, but I could. I mean, I don't generally order my food through Amazon, but I could.
It's worth trying out at these kind of savings.
Yeah, I suppose so. I get my hot sauce through Amazon.
You're a beef jerky guy, too.
So let's go to your phone calls and thoughts here. Go to saveitpurse.com. Get signed up right now. Don't wait. George is listening in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, George.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
Not much. I just wanted to clarify a couple things that I thought I heard, but I'm not sure that I did. First, let me state that I am not an official spokesperson for The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Okay.
But I am a member of that church.
Uh-huh.
And it's not really accurate to keep referring to it as the Mormon Church. Mormon was the name of a prophet. We are members of the Church of Jesus Christ.
Gotcha.
So
you don't call yourselves Mormons?
And a derogatory term. Generally not.
Interesting. I've never heard that before. We've talked to Mormons.
And that's the term they know. But I will always let them know that I'm a member of the Church of Jesus Christ. Hmm. Mormon was a prophet. You know, it's like calling somebody from the Church of Moses a Mosean. You know,
interesting.
They may be, but I'm a member of the Church of Jesus Christ.
Well, okay. So interestingly, I'm a Quaker, and that term was a derogatory term that was created by a judge, an English Correct. Judge, who actually said that he called them Quakers because they quaked with zeal. And, you know, the Quakers adopted it and used it for their, you know, sort of for their own purposes and, you know, made it a good thing. Yeah, they owned it.
So I've never heard this before. I mean, I'm not saying I disbelieve you, but we've had Mormons or we've had members of the Jesus Christ Church call the show, and they've never said that before.
And
is it uncommon?
It is not, and it is actually taught that when we refer to the church, we should refer to it as the Church of Jesus Christ, thus giving him the glory and not diverting it or having people think other ways. You know, the focus should be on Jesus Christ.
Don't you have to toss in the Latter-day Saints at the end in order to sort of distinguish? Because if somebody calls it the Church of Jesus Christ, I'm not going to know what they're talking about. They have to say Latter-day Saints.
It's not a bad idea, but the main thing is focus on Christ. I mean, it's pretty obvious it's after the Dark Ages, so it's not during the days of Christ. It's not the early-day church. It's the Latter-day Church. But it doesn't hurt to specify completely.
What is the official church doctrine regarding the end of the world? Because we know that the church came out, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, released a statement recently disclaiming the idea that the world would be ending on the blood moon here tonight. What is the official position of the church? Do you know?
Again, I am not the spokesman for the church, nor do I profess to be.
What did they teach you?
What is taught is what the scriptures say, which is not even the angels know the day when the Savior will come for the second time. Nobody knows. We don't know, and anybody who claims that they know
is a liar.
I think that's the best bet to go
that's
with.
It's a safe thing to say.
Because Paul, who wrote the majority of the books in the New Testament, claimed that it would happen soon. That was 2,000 years ago. So
correct.
It's pretty clear that dude didn't know.
And then something else you guys were saying, it's hard to tell because you kept saying, well, the Christians say, are you both Christians?
I am not. I
wouldn't call myself a Christian.
I'm a panentheist.
But I certainly wouldn't deny the fact that my faith is, to some extent, shaped by my Christian upbringing.
Now, I've never heard that term, panentheist. What
yeah, a panentheist, sort of similar to a pantheist. A pantheist, one who believes that everything is God. Well, the panentheist adds in the metaphysical to that, from my understanding. So believing that everything that exists is God and also whatever doesn't exist is also God. So...
wow, sure, that's meaningful
that's
to you.
That's very close to what the Native Americans believe.
Yeah, that wouldn't surprise me to be the case
with
at all.
The Great Spirit and everything is part of that energy. And
yeah, there are a lot of common threads between a lot of different religions. And so, yeah, it wouldn't surprise me that many Native Americans would have a pantheistic or panentheistic viewpoint. George, thanks for calling and sharing your thoughts. Anything else you want to get out there tonight?
Well, the only other thing was right when you got on the Bitcoin thing, somebody made the comment that, well, that's not going to happen either. I was hoping
what's
that you
not
were
gonna
referring
happen either.
To well, whatever the prediction was on the Bitcoin, and then the reference was that the end of the world isn't going to happen either. But I think that it was in reference to this crazy person who's saying it's going to be tonight.
Yeah, I'm willing to go down on the record and say that the world isn't going to end in the next 1,000 years.
24 hours. Okay.
Like that's
definitely not the next 24 hours.
Definitely not the next 24 hours. I just, for me, I've lived my, I grew up in the church, and then at one point or another, I got involved in a very serious Christian church. Let's call it that, the holiness movement. And these people were constantly believing that Jesus was coming just around the corner. And I don't want to live my life like the world's going to end anytime soon.
Exactly.
It's just not the way I want to be. I want to, I'm gonna go ahead and just go out on a limb here and say I'm gonna make it all the way to the end of my life. And Jesus isn't going to come in that amount of time.
Well, now, aren't
exactly.
there...
And that's a great way to look at it. And that's basically the view of the church, is that we prepare for the worst, but we expect the absolute best. You expect every day to wake up and go through your life and love your kids and your family. And that's the attitude everybody should have, is you prepare for the worst as best you can, but you expect the absolute best all the way to the end of your life, being healthy and...
Well, I like that. That's a nice viewpoint.
Happy life.
Thank you, George, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Thanks.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Now, Mark, aren't there Christians, preterists, I believe is the name,
yeah,
of Christians who believe that the predictions have already come true?
Right. The predictions as they were predicted
that's old news.
Are best interpreted as these are things that already occurred sort of in the first century with mm-hmm. The destruction of the temple and these sorts of things, and that people that are reading these things now don't understand how the application of the ideas of these predictions, that they're focused on their life as it's going on today, and that's how people tend to be, mm-hmm. but that these predictions as they existed, they all came to pass already. And that we're living in a different time, and of course, Jesus Christ is still relevant as far as the preterists are concerned. Just that the predictions, the Bible has no predictions for us, essentially.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype username is lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of O2Pure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary O2Pure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2Pure.
Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Want gold, but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Yeah! This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Whether it's the blood moon you want to talk about, you can do that. Or on the way, Mark, you'll be telling us about tag. It's been banned at one school or school district. I'm not sure which, but somebody has banned the classic children's game of tag because it's bad. It's dangerous.
Dangerous.
We'll get into that in moments.
What would you do when a bizarre cult army calling itself The Trust invades your sleepy little mountain hometown? We'll find out what James Contrell, a big-hearted country boy with a crappy job who's learned to live without dreams, and find out what he does. Because sometimes the guy who has learned to live without dreams might be the best suited to handle a nightmare. You can read the action, comedy, graphic novel James versus the New World Order by Brandon Bitros, illustrated by J. Matthew Root, the first in what's estimated to be a 5-volume, 24-issue series. So if this intrigues you...
It's comic books?
It's a graphic novel is a... I guess a comic book that's drawn well, and usually it's square bound or something, bound a bit differently. You know, it's a comic book with gravitas.
Got it.
Yes, but this is an art form. This is a way to transfer information, and a very good one too, because
people don't like to read.
Well, I think it allows the an expression in a different way that that just writing doesn't, and obviously just pictures
sure.
wouldn't. So
cool. It sounds neat.
It's great. James versus I checked it out. They've got a Kickstarter where they've got, you know, some art and those sorts of things. So you can see a bit of it. James versus the New World Order.com to contribute to the Kickstarter crowdfunding campaign to raise just $3,000 to pay for the artwork, the coloring, the production, and the distribution. This is what they need to get this off the ground. This is going to be a platform for the ideas of liberty to be transferred to some extent, too. Hmm. I believe this is the best form because once you can get somebody to read something, in the form of fiction, you can shape the narrative to get your ideas across. It's James versus the New World Order.com. James vs. the New World Order.com. The New World Order.
Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. Keith is listening in Des Moines. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark on the Live Sunday Show. Hey, Keith.
Yeah, hi. I heard you guys talking about Revelations, and what I have to say about that is, Will Rogers put it best, or was it Mark Twain? I forget.
Wait, I don't know, but they usually sound about the same.
Yeah, history doesn't always repeat, but it rhymes. So, if you look at Revelations, you look at most prophecies from almost any book, you can find relevance, in modern events. However, one thing about the book of Revelation, it actually has some very specific things, one of which is the talking about wormwood, which... If you want to go by the translation of the Ukrainian, it means black grass.
Black what?
Chernobyl means black grass.
Okay.
Black grass is actually another name for wormwood, which they use. They use for medicine, things like that. But one of the prophecies that it talks about is within the lifetime of people who see the. See Israel brought back onto the world stage as a nation state. But either way, though, if you want to look at, you look at Revelation, it's just it has a lot of things that are perpetually relevant. And one of the lessons in the New Testament is to be ye ever vigilant, for ye know not when the master cometh. So, it's basically for people who actually want to, be counted among the righteous to always be ready.
Well,
whether they get taken up in the
rapture. I kind of think that God's not going to destroy the things He's made, and I kind of think
you're not a Christian.
He loves His children, and He's what's that?
It's not destruction the way a lot of people think it is. It's not it's not the world. The world's not going to blow up.
That's good
you
news.
Have to actually read Revelation. It has a very happy ending.
I've read Revelations a couple of times, and I found it to be dizzying.
It's quite,
if you read it newly, right? Like you read it as though there aren't a bunch of crazy old white preachers that have told you what it means. If you just read it newly, it can mean anything. It just it sounds historical though.
What about the black preachers that I listen to?
I'm not claiming that. The claim is that that's what I listen to, and if you just ignore what you've heard. What about the young preachers you've listened to? What about the female preachers you've listened to?
Wait a minute. Well,
I'm stereotyping.
Wait, Keith, you said it's not going to be destructive. Now, isn't the Christian view, portion of the Revelations, isn't that where, the good Christians get pulled off the earth and then everybody else is, living in hell or something like that?
Yeah, the rest of us have to endure the tribulation.
That sounds kind of destructive.
Well, yeah, it's destructive, but you also have to remember, from destruction comes creation.
Well, that's an interesting point. Thanks, Keith, for the call tonight. Although, you know, destroying your creation in order to create a new version of it is still a destructive act. So first he says it's not destructive, then he admits that it is, in point of fact, destructive. And I get that, you know, when one door closes, another door opens, that I get that. But we're talking about people's lives here, right? We're talking about the destruction of purportedly millions of human lives.
In sales, what you do is you create urgency. So they'll say that, for instance, at an auto dealership, this is a big area for sales, right? Like auto dealership,
yeah, sure,
matters. At the end of the month, the last day of the month matters. Why does the last day of the month matter?
Quotas.
Because somebody said the last day of the month matters.
Mm-hmm.
Not because it's a real deadline. It's a created deadline. Now, it may be real for the company that's selling in the sense of the auto dealer, because the manufacturer sets these deadlines or whatever it is that they
new
do.
New inventory's coming in for 2016. We got to blow out all the 2015 models.
Right.
So by the end of this weekend.
You create an artificial sense of urgency, yeah, in sales. So if you want to, if what you're selling is conversions to a particular religion, you need artificial sense of urgency.
Mm.
And that's why the end times is such a great converter,
yeah,
when it comes
point.
To religion. I say Christianity. I don't know much about other religions, frankly, in comparison to what I know about Christianity.
Right.
But Christianity may very well be the perfect religion for sort of conversions. You've got the carrot of heaven. You've got the stick of hell. You've got the artificial
Muslims
sense.
Have that too.
What's that?
Islam,
right,
has
I don't
that.
Know that much about okay. it and how it works. I'm not going to critique Islam because I don't know much about Islam.
I gotcha.
But you know, Christianity really has this whole thing going.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, all you got to do is repeat after me, and then you're in. And then, you know, at that point, maybe you should come to church more often, and don't forget donating
10%.
And all that stuff.
Right.
But you know, it basically the threshold, the cost for you know, entering in, the cost for the sale is low. The cost for not making the sale is extraordinarily high. The artificial sense of urgency is going
right.
on. There's all this stuff for the closing. Here's what I've got to say is that my God, the God I believe in, is not a raging psychopath. And so therefore, I refuse to believe
like the New Testament God?
Any of your stories about hell. Off the table.
Yeah.
Like, I'm done with the conversation about hell. And that's what the end times is all about. It's all about, let's blow the planet up. Everybody who doesn't believe what they're supposed to believe at the given time, they're going to, you know, be tortured or end up in hell or whatever the story is. And I'm done. Nope. Fooey, mm-hmm. not listening to your story about hell. Your story about hell is a place created by a raging psychopath that wants to put their children, that torture their children for all of eternity.
Well, the story was created by men who wanted to encourage you to join their church and give them a bunch of money.
That's what you get. Now, some people will say that hell is simply the separation from God,
mm-hmm.
which case you're existing. Many people, the vast majority of the planet, I would say, is existing in hell already. If separation from God is hell,
mm-hmm.
then, you know, big deal. They're doing it already. I guess hell isn't so bad. I don't know. Wouldn't claim to know what it is, but I just don't believe that. I wouldn't treat my son this way. I wouldn't say
tell him scary stories to scare him straight. That kind
God
of thing.
Doesn't tell me any scary stories.
Yeah.
God hasn't told me anything.
You got to take the preacher's word for it.
I've got to take somebody's word for it. I've got to take this dubious book that has been put out there, and you know, there's all these questions
passed
about it
through countless hands of men.
Right, and I'm supposed to believe that political leaders and you know, folks haven't changed the words, that it's not like Jesus, it's not like God came to earth and wrote some things down, right? He was teaching the scribes in the temple at 12 years old. Let's say he might have been learned, but he didn't bother writing anything down, and if he did, he didn't keep it for us to look at.
The Blood Moon. Are you freaked out? Is this your last night on Earth? Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE, the actual eclipse is supposed to be starting here in a little bit. 855-450-3733. This is the live Sunday show of Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, September 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports the Kurdistan Workers Party, PKK, issued a statement on Friday claiming that multiple ambush attacks against the Turkish military has left 19 security forces dead, including 16 soldiers and 3 members of the National Police Force. These attacks were carried out over the course of the last couple of days and sparked another round of Turkish military retaliation, mostly in the form of airstrikes, with the military issuing a statement saying that 34 PKK fighters were killed in its attacks. The incidents took place along the Turkish border with Iraq. Turkey's southeast is predominantly Kurdish, and the PKK is active both there and in northern Iraq, which has also been the target of multiple airstrikes. Kurdish Member of Parliament Salma Armak reported that PKK leader Abdullah Öcalan, still in Turkish prison, has reiterated his support for a return to the 2-year ceasefire that was in place before Turkey launched airstrikes against the group late in July. Turkey has suggested that they have no intention to return to a ceasefire without a unilateral disarmament of the entire PKK and the group relocating wholly to Iraq. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Swiss authorities have banned the sale of Volkswagen diesel engine cars that may have been fitted with emission testing cheating devices. The move, seen as temporary, puts a stop to the sale of some 180,000 Volkswagen models not yet sold or registered in the country and comes after the company was accused of using software to doctor emission testing results. Thomas Rohrbach, spokesman for the Swiss Federal Office of Roadways, said the ban was being implemented on Volkswagen vehicles with diesel engines in the Euro 5 emissions category. The ban does not apply to cars with Euro 6 engines, which are able to meet tougher emission standards set by the European Union. The move comes after the United States Environmental Protection Agency recalled 482,000 diesel-powered Volkswagens that had apparent defeat device software to allow the vehicles to cheat emissions tests. Since diesel vehicles are more popular in Europe, Volkswagen is receiving far more scrutiny there. Earlier in the week, Volkswagen chief Martin Winterkorn resigned. Matthias Mueller, the former head of Porsche, has been named the Volkswagen chief executive. Mueller said, "My most urgent task is to win back the trust of the Volkswagen group by leaving no stone unturned and with maximum transparency, as well as drawing the right conclusions from the current situation."
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports separatist parties are expected to win control of Catalonia's parliament in an election on Sunday, setting the region on course for a unilateral declaration of independence from Spain, which the central government says is impossible. Opinion polls indicate the main secessionist platform, Together for Yes, and leftist party CUP are likely to fall short of 50% of the vote, but they will still secure a majority of seats in the 135-strong regional assembly. Both have said that such a result would allow them to unilaterally declare independence within 18 months. The Spanish center-right government of Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy, which has opposed any attempt to hold a referendum on secession, has called the breakaway plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. While a breakaway by the wealthy northeastern autonomous region is still very much seen as a theoretical question, even in Catalonia, analysts say the election result will bear long-lasting consequences at local and countrywide levels. The secessionist campaign is facing a defining moment as support for the cause has steadily waned since its peak in 2013. Any failure to achieve a majority of seats would deal a serious blow to the movement. The vote may also act as a catalyst for the Spanish general election due in December. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. Gushing women voters announced Monday that they just can't help but feel an uncontrollable attraction to the sexist Republican Party. Saying they should know better but just can't resist the GOP's reckless neglect of women's health issues, smitten females across the country are reportedly driven wild by the GOP's blatant chauvinism.
I can't say no to bold, misogynistic politicians who think their authority extends to my uterus. Whenever you vote for a Republican, you feel like you're doing something a little bit naughty.
Top officials within the U.S. military acknowledged Wednesday that they were desperate to be given just one solid war they could really knock out of the park. Citing the recent string of messy, ambiguous military engagements in the Middle East, members of the Pentagon brass called for a conflict against a sovereign nation with a standing army and a clear-cut bad guy who employs conventional tactics and weaponry.
No roadside bombs, no plainclothes militants siding out among innocent civilians. Just a fair fight where two sides shoot at each other and someone wins. We're absolutely great at that.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The Blood Moon is scheduled to begin shortly. Space.com has a live cam, the start of the umbral eclipse, which I believe is the very beginning of the lunar eclipse that's supposed to be happening here shortly, is slated to happen in about 1 minute from now. The peak, that is the time at which the moon is completely submerged in the darkest part of the Earth's shadow, is expected at about 10:47 Eastern. And some are saying that this is portending the end of the world. Certain Mormons and Christians are preparing for the end here tonight. And if you're one of them, I'd love to hear from you. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can also join us online over at freetalklive.com. You can call us up on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. And with you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Let's go to Dana. She's in Grand Rapids listening to WTKG. Hello, Dana.
Hi. Hi, Ian. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Dana.
A couple of comments. First of all, the gentleman who called correcting the usage of Mormonism, he said that not even the angels would know the time. That's not exactly true. It's not even the Son of God knows the time. Well, not the Holy Ghost. Only the Father. So I
wish I understood that a little more. Like how, because yes, you're told God's one being, and then it's three beings, and then so part of him doesn't know.
It's three persons in one God, and you know what? I was.
Hello?
Dana?
Dana? Oh, wow. I don't know what happened there.
The kind of information that she has is so valuable, it couldn't be allowed to broadcast on the air.
Her phone line is still open? Connected, still open. We'll put her back on hold, see if we can get her back here in a moment. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, is 855-450-FREE. But you touched on an interesting point there, Mark, and that is the Christian religion. One of the main things that separates the Muslim beliefs from the Christian beliefs is that the Muslims believe one God, that there is no triune God.
Essentially, to some extent, it can be argued that that Islam is essentially the most successful of the Unitarian sects. Mm-hmm. So there's these folks out there called Unitarians. They got together with the Universalists a few decades ago, but they were a separate organization, and they probably should be. It's just that, you know, churches are kind of dwindling these days. So they got together and put their assets together. It was more of a financial arrangement. But the Unitarians believe strongly that, that there's only one God, that there's not three, that it's one. And that was the idea, as do Muslims. Universalists believe everybody goes to heaven.
And so what Dana was saying there is that Jesus, who purportedly by the Christian beliefs is God, would not actually know when the end times were, which would suggest that Jesus, in point of fact, is not actually God.
Not all-knowing, at least.
Right. Because, well, in order to be God, you have to be all-knowing.
But if there's three
by
beings...
By the Christians' beliefs.
Three beings inside one God, then if those three beings know one-third of each thing, of all the information that there is to know, then God knows everything, I guess.
Yeah, that would be a workaround. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We're going to give Dana another shot here. She called back. Dana, go ahead.
I don't know what happened. I apologize if it was my fault.
I don't think so. Go ahead.
Okay, it's three beings in one God, and each has their purpose. You know what I was taught? This is where I lost you guys. Don't dwell on it too much, because those are what we call mysteries as Christians. We will find this out when we have pure knowledge during our life review at death, because all that is a temptation from Satan. And so don't dwell on
what's a temptation from Satan specifically?
Yeah, clear that up for me again. What was the temptation?
When we dwell too much on these things, it's nothing more than a temptation from Satan.
Okay. Dwelling on the end of the world, you mean?
No. Dwelling on what's the three people in one God? Are they not God?
Wait a minute. Asking questions is not, I'm sorry, but asking questions is not a satanic thing.
You're misunderstanding. Ian, you're misunderstanding. I'm saying that in a nice way. No, it's good to ask questions, but I was always taught don't dwell too much, because it's Satan trying to mess with your head. You know, well, how can this be? Well, what about this? Then they must not really be God, you know, and who's God and who isn't? So, you know, it's good to question. I'm not saying don't question. Question everything, religion, government, people,
but
everything.
Don't question too much.
But not where it's making you doubt the existence. Now,
I don't doubt God. I just don't believe the Christian story completely.
Okay, and that's your choice. And then Mark said something about Paul. Now, if God is the Alpha and Omega, and if he's infinite, he always was and always will be, if Paul said God is coming soon, 2,000 years, you said, Mark, he hasn't shown up yet, could be a relatively short time. Soon in God's time is completely different than in our existence. And another thing you said, Mark, was why do I need all these cryptic messages? Why can't God just tell me? He did. He said to look to the heavens for the sign. We need to look to the heavens. He gave us Christ. Either you believed or you didn't. And his story transcended all these years. And if you're prepared, like a previous gentleman said, if you're prepared, does it really matter if this is a blood moon and it means something?
It doesn't matter, ultimately,
really
right?
Matter?
You're either saved or you're not saved. And if you're not, then the blood moon might be a bit terrible thing for you. But whatever,
but,
you know.
But don't disillusion yourself, Mark. Please, don't pretend there's not a hell. Read some of these life after death. There's Wait a minute. Just let me finish. There's more that have had positive experiences than negative. But even Jesus Christ, in those 3 days he was dead after the cross, the crucifixion, he descended into hell and then rose into heaven, then came back to earth, and then eventually, you know, the Holy Spirit came down, said goodbye to the apostles, did some preaching, and then he returned to the right hand of his Father.
Yeah, this is.
And I know that's a Christian belief.
I find these after-deaths scenarios to be the most compelling and interesting evidence for sort of, you know, an afterlife and that kind of thing. I do often wonder. Because, I mean, many times people who preach of having been to heaven or having been to hell can go on the church preaching circuit, and they can essentially be paid as speakers and public speakers. And that always bugs me as to how true their story is, because they write a book and then they go on the speaking tour and they can basically travel the United States and have a reasonably good job, you know, making money by talking to folks.
Hey, Dana, is it possible that the authors of the Bible got some of it wrong?
It may be. But the thing is the overall message, you know, don't murder, don't fornicate.
Well,
you know,
I like the don't murder part, but
you guys, look,
I don't see what's wrong with fornication.
He gave 10 rules. They got to be.
Fornication was not in those 10 rules.
They got to be pretty, but listen.
Was it now? Fornication, sex outside of marriage, was not in the 10 commandments, correct?
No, and I don't disagree with that. No, but
so
you know.
Fornicate away then, right?
Now, do you think that's what God would want?
Wouldn't God want his creations to feel good? What's wrong with that?
I think there's a reasonable argument that if you are out there fornicating up a storm, that you're going to get something that itches.
That's
and
true.
You don't want to itch.
Thanks, Dana, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I also don't want babies either.
One of my arguments, you're neutered, and thank
right.
God for everybody. One of the things that, you know, I always heard sort of as an argument for Christianity in the past is that, you know, there's a lot of some of these rules they lay down, pretty good rules for life. If you, you know, you don't drink, you don't smoke, you don't fornicate, you're probably going to have a reasonably good life.
But even
Jesus
turned
water to wine.
About
Quakers is that Quakers came to do good, and they did rather well in the process.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts here with us on Free Talk Live. Also, Skype in at username lrn.fm.
Has this ever happened to you? You're applying for some type of a loan, whether online or in person, and when it's time to hit submit, your nerves spike because you're not sure you'll get the approval you seek. There's a different way to approach life. It's called Credit Success Secrets Revealed. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is a revolutionized step-by-step system that you can follow to get all the credit you desire today. We're talking about secured and unsecured credit, car leases, credit cards, and cash. Call 800-568-8960. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works no matter what your current situation, whether you've had bad credit, never had credit, or looking for some business credit, or any type of credit. Please call 800-568-8960. We don't take any personal information. Your personal information is way too valuable to trust to a third-party email or a website that doesn't answer the phone. At Credit Success Secrets Revealed, we show you step-by-step what to place into the financial computer systems that control your credibility in the marketplace today. We practically fill out the forms for you. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time. Call now, 800-568-8960. That's 800-568-8960. 800-568-8960.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, Neocash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
BlakeDevelopment.net is a global leader in website creation, app development, and online marketing, catering to businesses of all sizes. There's really no job too big or too small for BlakeDevelopment.net. Do you have an idea for a killer app, but you don't know how to code it? Are you missing out on online sales? Or maybe your business needs help with social media. Websites start at just $200, and they're offering 3 years of free domain registry. Yes, they take Bitcoin. 844-SITE-123. BlakeDevelopment.net, 844-SITE-123.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you want here on the live Sunday edition tonight. It's Ian here.
And Mark.
And you get online at all? Well, you need to know about ProXPN if you care about privacy when you're online. They're a virtual private network. They encrypt your online data before it reaches your internet service provider, so your ISP will no longer know what you're doing with their internet connection. And that's valuable because it means your ISP can't sell your data. They can't mine it for their own purposes. They can't turn it over to the government because they have no clue once you start using ProXPN. You can start that by going to proxpn.com/amp. There's a new offer on the table from ProXPN. Now, you can still use our old code FTL50. That gets you 50% off their regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you get their annual account. That code's still good. But if you've got Bitcoin, then you're going to want to use this link, proxpn.com/amp. You pay with Bitcoin, you then get 2 years worth of ProXPN for only $49.95, so less than $50 worth of Bitcoin, and $5 of your purchase price will go to the Free Talk Live AMP program to help us spread the ideas of liberty and Bitcoin and privacy and all that stuff. So you're getting a great deal. This is the best deal yet on ProXPN. And you're helping Free Talk Live. When you go to proxpn.com/amp, that's /AMP, as in advertise, market, and promote, like the Free Talk Live AMP program. It's a huge savings, but that discount is only available when you pay with Bitcoin. So go to proxpn.com/amp. And of course, if you don't have Bitcoin, you can still use their old code FTL50 to get that 50% off deal and take advantage of the new offer over at proxpn.com/amp and help spread the ideas of liberty and take back your privacy. As we continue here, let's go to John in Nevada on Skype. Hello, John.
Hi. I'm an ex-Roman Catholic, and as I follow the Pope this week and follow the political prescriptions he's making, I can't help but be struck by how flatly these prescriptions contradict what I was taught by the church about Jesus. You know, I wish someone would ask the Pope, who would Jesus jail for peaceful dissent? And then realize that, you know, all of these policies, many of these political policies that he's championing entail that. They require that peaceful dissenters, be thrown in jail. For instance,
what are some of the policies he's championing? I pay zero attention to this man, so I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, well, I'll just give you two basic areas. One obvious one is he favors, you know, the redistribution of wealth, that money should be taken from some people to give to the poor. Now, charity's nice, but
Jesus didn't advocate for, advocated for charity. He didn't advocate for the Roman government to come and take money from people and give it to other people.
Right. I look at Erwin Schiff, who's probably going to die in prison mm-hmm. for peaceful dissent on taxes. And I ask myself, well, what part of that would Jesus play? Would he be the guy locking him in the cell, or would he be the guy just saying, no, we need this law to put him in jail, but I won't do it myself, but someone else better do it? I don't think so.
Yep. That doesn't sound like Jesus at all.
Also, the Pope is, he's for the illegalization of drugs. You know, he doesn't think it was a good idea to legalize marijuana. He wants drugs to be made illegal, and the same arguments apply. You know, would Jesus lock someone up for smoking pot? I'm pretty sure he wouldn't.
Highly unlikely.
I don't know how Catholic people, you know, who were taught the same things I was taught in the church can reconcile those teachings. It just doesn't seem possible.
Yeah, it's the Pope's position is one that has evolved to some extent from it was an emperor essentially ruled over land and that sort of thing. So of course they're highly statist folks, and I don't understand how statists can really be Christians, frankly, because the Bible I read. The character of Jesus in the Bible I read was a person who was about peace, love, and convincing people to act morally, not forcing them. He hung out with thieves in the form of tax collectors, government agents was what these guys, and prostitutes, and basically the worst people of their time. I think this is a terrible thing to do, is to lump prostitutes in with government agents.
Right, an honest working lady with scumbags.
Nonetheless, that's the idea. And, Jesus just wouldn't do that. But Christians who are statists, who have been brought up this way, are happy to vote their conscience, which means bringing down the machinations of the state, putting people in prison who haven't harmed anyone that Jesus would never put in prison. That's not very Christian. Christians are Christ-like.
Supposedly, that's the idea.
Well, no, they are.
Yeah.
The Christians are Christ-like. The people who call themselves Christians aren't Christians.
Are not Christians. So, John, you said you were raised Catholic, is that right?
Yeah, Roman Catholic.
So,
I was well into my adulthood.
Now, I don't know a whole lot about Catholicism, but it was my understanding that the Pope is sort of like the one man in the church with a direct line to God. Isn't that the idea? Like he's the one who communicates with God.
There is a doctrine of limited infallibility in some very specific contexts, but it's not like everything that comes out of his mouth is the word of God.
And people don't really believe that, right? Catholics don't really believe that this guy's the conduit from God. He's just a powerful guy in the church, right?
Yeah, I can't say that even when I was a devout Catholic, I was really convinced that the Pope ever had infallibility. So,
but what about the people around you? Are the other Catholics? Do they think similarly, or do they believe that he's infallible? I mean, do the Catholics believe that if it comes out of the Pope's mouth, that it could override or sort of update the Bible's words?
Well, I would say that my parents were more conventionally pious people than me. I was devout, but I was always a person who asked questions and tried to resolve them. Say, my parents were more conventionally pious and pretty much accepted what was said without questioning it too much. So they wouldn't really have sophisticated views on, they say the Pope's infallible. Sometimes I guess he is, would be their position. Hmm.
Thanks for calling and sharing your thoughts here tonight, John. I appreciate hearing from you. As the lunar eclipse has begun, the space.com feed showing the moon is in its first phase of what will eventually be a total eclipse, resulting in what is called a blood moon. Some in certain religions, including the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and other Christians, are freaking out about this, saying that the world is going to end. This is the the harbinger for the apocalypse here. And if you're one of those believers, we want to hear from you tonight.
What does the end of the world mean? Because for different people, it means different things. You know, like the death card in the tarot doesn't mean death. It means change. Mm-hmm. And so the end of the world as we know it, well, the end of the world has ended as we know it
many times
throughout my life. I can make that mean whatever you wish
to make the internet change the world for the better, for good.
Well, some people would disagree.
Right.
And speaking of the end of the world, many people will claim that the Pope, and the Pope, of course, the Pope is the Antichrist. A lot of people, they're always predicting this Pope is the Antichrist. Oh, no, this Pope. This Pope is the Antichrist. Just keeps on coming and coming.
855.
The Antichrist is like the end of the world. It's a moving target.
855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More on these predictions here in moments, and you can share your thoughts with us here on the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. You can Skype in at lrn.fm. It's Free Talk Live.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Shortly after being fired from his coding position at a downsizing tech firm, 34-year-old Irvine native Sam Morrison told reporters Monday that he believed he had finally achieved the sort of work-life balance for which he has long strived.
Yeah, ever since I got fired, it just seems like my whole entire routine is just clicking. I go for jogs in the afternoon, spend nights with my wife and kid, I'm even cooking more. Everything just feels right.
Morrison, who since his termination has found time to pick up reading again, eat a healthy diet, and sleep more than 5 hours a night, noted that his unemployment has allowed him to find a level of harmony in his personal life that he never before thought possible.
For a while there, I thought that I was going to spend the rest of my life constantly worrying about getting to the office on time and pleasing my boss. Outside of the late payments on the house, the mounting credit card debt, the rapidly depleting savings, my life is essentially stress-free. I honestly couldn't be happier.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is $6 lower at $1,147 per ounce. Silver is down 2 cents at $15.18 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $236. The prospect for getting ahead on silver American Eagles looks bad, but we have plenty of spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week.
See what's happening at freekeen.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeen.com. That's freekeen.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. If you are a believer that the Blood Moon is going to be the end of the world. Now, is it going to just begin the end of the world when the Blood Moon is over, or will the world actually be abolished completely by the end of the Blood Moon? Is it the middle of the moon where it's like completely
dark? Well, that's more exciting
dark?
To think, but I don't imagine, I don't know. Usually when people say the end of the world, they're talking about a series of events.
Yeah.
They did talk about this situation with the Blood Moon being four different lunar eclipses.
This is the fourth of the four.
This is the fourth of the four, yeah. But I don't know.
Texas hedge pastor John Hagee.
I can tell
Hagee.
You if you're saying that it's over, that by the end of the evening, you'll have a new prediction.
Yeah. And that's one of the things about these guys, these religious leaders who will go out on a limb and make a prediction like this. It's a risky thing for them to do,
sure,
right?
Is.
Because when you claim that the alien spaceship is going to come by and pick everybody up, what was this, the Heaven's Gate people back in the 90s, I think it was?
Something like that.
You had to go and prepare yourself for the alien spacecraft that will come and take you away before the end of the world. And then when that doesn't happen, then there's usually an excuse that someone will make. The religious leader
will
make.
In that case, they killed themselves, didn't they?
Did the Heaven's Gate people? Yeah, they did, I think.
Yeah,
right,
so,
about
I mean,
that.
They made it to the alien spaceship as far as anyone's concerned.
But there are some others that, have prepared for the end, and then ultimately the end didn't come. And it's interesting, there have been studies done on the people who've been in these, religious belief systems, cults, or whatever you want to call them, on how they handle this news. These are people who have prepared themselves for the end. I mean, if they take it seriously, then they've, in a lot of cases, sold their houses. They have sold their possessions or given them away. I mean, we've jokingly said on the air, hey, if you think the world's going to end, go ahead and send us your PayPal, account or whatever. Transfer your Bitcoin to us. Go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com if you really mean that. But we're joking about that, obviously. But the people who really do believe in some of these theories about the world ending and their religious leader has chosen a specific date and time, many of them really will sell everything that they own or give it away and prepare themselves literally for the end, only to find out that the end, in point of fact, didn't come. And when you look at how
they're lucky if the end didn't come. For some of them, plenty of them, the end did come.
You mean when they've suicided? I'm talking about the ones who didn't suicide.
Right, I know.
So when you look at how they, they handle that, how does the religious leader play it off? Well, I remember there was one story, and I'm sorry, I don't remember which cult it was, but that the religious leader, as they were waiting and waiting for the end of the world to come, that one of these cult leaders said that he had received a new message from God. That the new message was that the end of the world had been delayed due to the beliefs of the followers, the believers, and their passion for their particular religion. God had changed his mind and had changed his mind about ending the world because of you, right? Like, this is what he pitched to them. And it worked on some of them, right? Like, oh, wow, wow, that's so great.
I think that you're talking about Dorothy Martin in 1954.
Was she the religious leader in question?
I believe that's who you're talking about, yeah. For the story that you're referring to.
Okay.
I think that sounds like her pitch.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's fascinating to, to look at the excuse for, look, you failed. Your prediction was an abject failure. But no, at the last moment, God has sent you a message to clarify his prediction and that he's changed his mind. He has staved off the end of the world because of your true beliefs. And the question is, what percentage of the religious followers in that particular case believed it? What percentage of them
believed it and continued on in the cults versus the percentage of them that realized, oh, we've been had.
Usually they
don't out of here.
Usually they don't leave, but sometimes there'll be schism. There was there was a case with Florence Hauteff in the 50s also. She made a prediction like this, and when that didn't happen, and I think it didn't happen a couple of times.
Oh, boy.
And then there was a split as a result, and then you know different groups came along. But the people that tend to be in these highly immersive cults, I'm not talking about regular religious folks. I'm talking about these highly immersive cult situations. Mm-hmm. They've got – they're a personality type that can – their faith is so strong that it doesn't matter what reality is like.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
So it doesn't matter. Oh, well, the interpretation of what was going on is now this.
Right.
Okay, I get it. I see what the interpretation is. And so if you can construct a narrative around it, then fine.
Yeah, and it sounds like it only needs to be semi-plausible because these people aren't going to question it very hard. But yeah. I still find myself wondering the breakdown. You know, of 100 cult followers, what percentage of them
finally comes to their senses?
Because some of them do. Because, you know, they people go in different directions after a prediction like this goes south.
Well, I never, picked a date by any stretch of the imagination. But I was in a holiness Christian a belief system.
When was this?
This was in prison.
Okay.
And there was a guy that would come and preach to us. And there were several of us that were just, you know, into it. And, this was probably for about a year there or whatever. And what I really faithfully believed that the end was coming very, very soon. And I had hoped that it was, that I got long enough that I could get out of prison. And I've been out 15 years or something like that. And I just... You know, in many ways, sort of that time feels like I was tricked. Feels like I wasted that time.
You were in prison, so there was only so much you could do.
Agreed. And
you could have read other books, I suppose.
There's value to the group that I hung out with. These were good guys, no stretch. I'm not here calling anyone stupid or anything like that. I just kind of feel tricked, like things didn't come the way that they were supposed to. If you put your money into an investment and the expectation is that you're going to make 20% on the outside of the investment, if you don't make 20% or you lose your money or whatever, you're going to feel tricked and bad. And I feel that way.
Well, I don't think that you should. When you put money into an investment, you should expect that you could lose it all. That's what investments can do.
Yeah. Well, then people don't put money into things where they can lose it all.
Generally, when you're investing money, you can lose it all, right?
You can, Ian, but if you don't put money in with the belief that that's what's going to happen.
You don't have the expectation that that's going to happen.
See, expectation's what it's all about.
But you should understand that that's possible.
The world's based on expectation. The world of dealing with other human beings is all about expectation. So when dealing with them, you should create expectations that you can fulfill. The expectation that the world is going to end on such and such a date is an expectation likely you cannot fill.
Let's talk about John Hagee, the Texas pastor who is he's not in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Do they call them pastors in that church? I don't know. John Hagee, though, is an advocate of a theory around these blood moons, and he even wrote a book about it called Four Blood Moons, Something is About to Change. He said in a statement this week, God is trying to tell us something. The fourth blood moon is part of the last tetrad of this kind in the 21st century. It's slated to unfold overnight tonight into the early morning hours Eastern time. As the Blaze has previously reported, Hagee has explained that blood moons are named for the reddish color that results when the Earth comes between the sun and the moon. It gets a bit complicated, but to boil Hagee's theory down, he contends that these purported messages from God are coming through tetrads that involve four separate blood moons, all falling on Jewish holidays. He, in his latest book, writes, quote, It is rare that scripture, science, and history align with each other.
I recall that the idea in prison was to claim that you were Jewish so that you got more holidays, that they had the most holidays. So,
and getting a holiday in jail meant what?
Whatever the benefit was. But, this is something I recall is that there might be a lot of Jewish holidays, so moons showing up on Jewish holidays may not be that unusual.
He said yet that the last three series of the four blood moons have done exactly that. This is the fourth of the four. Just as in biblical times, he says, God is controlling the sun, the moon, and the stars to send our generation a signal that something big is about to happen. Now, predictions like this, are so easy to claim that they're fulfilled, right? You know, because there's always something big that happens. There's something, an earthquake is going to happen tomorrow or in the next hour, somewhere in the world. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100. And things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company. 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away. So you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We've got enough time for you if you want to join us now. No true Blood Moon believers tonight. There must not be that many of them. People who believe that the world is coming to an end because of the Blood Moon or some sort of long, drawn-out theory about Israel. having something to do with four blood moons in a row or four kind of moons. Not four blood moons, because it's 18 years for every blood moon, apparently. But the tetrad, as they're calling it, which is four moon lunar kind of events that happen within like 2 year time frames. There's the fourth of the tetrad happening here tonight. It is considered a blood moon. We're actually in the middle of it. If you want to watch video footage of this happening, because some parts of the world you cannot see this. So if you can go outside and watch it, obviously that's the best way to do it. But if it's cloud cover or whatever, you can go to space.com, where their video feed was working until just a moment ago, and now there's service unavailable is what's coming up there. But if you want to share your thoughts with us, 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. It's 855-450-3733. And coming up here in just about a month from now, it's going to be Keenvention. The third annual Keenvention is happening here in our very own Keene, New Hampshire, at the Best Western Sovereign Plus Hotel. There will be something like 11 panel discussions happening at Keenvention, covering everything from legislative action here in New Hampshire to cop blocking to what it's like to be a brand new mover here as part of the Free State Project, the New Movers Panel, as it is being called, the Bitcoin Panel, which is probably going to be the most important Bitcoin panel we've had yet at Keenvention. This one's going to feature Gavin Andreessen, who is the head programmer behind Bitcoin today. He's going to be on the Bitcoin panel this
year. That's a big deal.
This is a huge deal. And so you can attend Keenvention for just $60 for the entirety of the weekend, or you can pay in Bitcoin. Just go to keenvention.info. It's happening October 30th through November 1st. There are a lot of cool social events that are going on, like a bonfire and a costume dance party. Of course, it's Halloween weekend, or Hallowkeen weekend, as we like to say here. And it's, again, $60 or Bitcoin. Just go to keenvention.info. You can learn more. There's still some more full panels that have yet to be announced. Those are still to come. We got great keynote speakers lined up. It's a great event, and it's intimate, meaning that's small, meaning there aren't that many people that attend Keenvention. So you really get time to spend with the people that you want to meet. You know, if you've heard these names of these activists that we've talked about here on the air, that we've, many of them we've had behind microphones, the movers, the shakers, the doers here in New Hampshire, dozens of them are going to be at Keenvention. It's a great opportunity to bend their ear, ask them questions, and, you know, learn from some of the people who've actually been out there on the streets and in the state house and, you know, getting active for the ideas of liberty. You can do that at Keenvention at keenvention.info. So, Mark, we're sharing with you here a little bit more information about the predictions that some have been making, including one man, John Hagee, a Texas pastor who wrote a book about the four blood moons.
He's written a lot of books.
Has he? Okay, I don't know much about this guy. He claims that God is sending a signal that something big is about to happen. In a 2013 interview with The Blaze, Hagee said that the premise of his theory is confirmed by NASA.
The premise is confirmed by NASA.
He argued that a series of four blood moons have appeared on Passover and Sukkot, also known as the Feast of Tabernacles, during the period of two consecutive years, only a few times in history. Passover celebrates the Jews' liberation from Egyptian slavery, and Sukkot commemorates the Jews' 40-year wandering in the desert.
History, the current history sort of claims that Jews weren't imprisoned, that no one was, the slave labor did not build the pyramids, at least.
And each time Hagee said something significant has happened concerning the Jewish people, he says that this has happened only three times in over 500 years, so it's a very rare thing, adding that the dates during
three times in 500 years? Not that rare.
Adding that the dates during which the tetrads fell always began with tears and ended in triumph. The current tetrad includes blood...
For the Jews.
The current tetrad that includes blood moons that appeared on April 15th, 2014, October 8th, 2014, and April 4th, 2015, with the final event taking place on September 28th, which is tomorrow. I'm confused, Mark. I thought the blood moons only happen once every 18 years. How can there be blood moons every 2 years or more than once a year if they supposedly happen every 18 years? Is it like a special blood moon that happens only every 18 years? I'm only asking you because you're sitting across from me, not that I expect that you actually know the
answer. I think I might have a shot at it. Lunar eclipses are not particularly rare, as opposed to, say, solar eclipses. So maybe you're thinking of a lunar eclipse occurring, say, every 18 months or 2 years. But what he's talking about is the correspondence to Jewish holidays here as being extraordinarily rare. Does that sound right to you?
Yeah, I guess I see what you're saying, but what about the 18-year thing? I don't
really know what the 18-year
thing is. I don't know.
I'm sorry.
If you know, you can clue us in here. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Of course, not all Christians agree, and there are critics. In a 2014 interview with The Blaze, Christian expert Hank Hanegraaff, the Bible answer man, says the theory is appalling and deplorable and dismissed it.
Well, I think that that's generally a safe thing for Christians to do when it comes to Christians claiming that there's going to be some kind of prediction that can be made. That the best bet is to say, you don't know. The Bible is very cryptic in the way it makes predictions for a reason. And it's because you're not supposed to know. So whatever. I think it's best. The best bet is to leave these predictions alone. It doesn't look good when you're wrong, and the chances of you being wrong are historically quite high.
Yeah. Let's go to Drew. He's calling on Skype. Hello, Drew. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey. Okay. So the deal with the super moon being the 18 years.
Yeah.
The lunar eclipses are pretty common, like Mark was saying, and generally they're going to be red, so that's why they're called the blood moon. But the 18 years coincidence is that it's the super moon at the same time as the lunar eclipse.
So blood moon plus the super moon, which means that the moon should be larger than normal and it will be blood, kind of red colored.
Yep. And even the super moon is common too. Like every few full moons is technically a super moon, so
yeah,
you get
like
several per year. Yeah, every few full moons or so is actually a super moon, but it's just really hard to actually tell what the difference is because the size, it's so small in the sky that you can't really tell the difference.
Yeah,
really?
If it has to be close to the horizon, the super moon isn't double the size of the moon.
Okay.
It is some small percentage. I think, like, I don't know, maybe 17% comes to mind.
I call false advertising on that. I mean, that doesn't sound very super to me.
What do you want? Yeah, do you want it to come crashing into Earth?
I don't know. It'd be nice to have it double the size.
If you want to see the moon look really big and beautiful, go online. They have pictures. They have photographs where people have enlarged the moon artificially, and it looks great.
Hey, Drew, anything else you want to share tonight?
No, that's it.
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate it. That's what I love about Free Talk Live, man. People can call in and correct us any old time, whenever we spout off something that is incorrect or not quite correct.
It's common enough.
Yeah, I appreciate it when folks call in who actually know something about what they're saying. Because we're just talk show hosts. We don't know anything.
My favorite thing about the full moon is in winter here in New Hampshire, when you have snow on the ground.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So when the full moon comes out, It's
glowing.
Right. The ground glows. And I like to go for hikes. Now, so far, I've always come back. But there's, basically no one knows I go out on these hikes. And,
you don't even tell your wife, huh?
My wife doesn't live here during the winter.
Oh, that's right.
So, I go out on these hikes and it's beautiful. There's nothing like it. I love to, see if I can, just put some minor hike under my belt each time. Say, I'm going to go here, I'm going to go there, and just kind of experience it and then come back. It's really wonderful. I love the full moons for that.
Video feed appears to be working again over at space.com. The moon is going to be entering into another phase of this eclipse here, covered up right now on their video feed. They had a little timer that shows you when the next phase is supposed to begin.
Mm-hmm.
So that should be coming up shortly after the 10 o'clock Eastern hour. And I don't think the world's going to be ending, but it sure is fun to entertain the people who believe that it is, to hear what they believe is going to occur. And, of course, you're still welcome to call in about this, even if we're all still here tomorrow. You can give us your next prediction for when the world's going to end.
I expect to make it here tomorrow.
Yep. And don't forget...
What does Hagee say? I mean, I really never got the end of it. Did he say that... It was all going to end?
No, actually.
Just the things were going to be different for Jews. It was going to start with tears and end with triumph.
He just basically said that it's God's trying to send some sort of message. But I guess you'll have to read his book, Mark, if you really want to believe know what he believes.
Yeah.
But who really cares? We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Don't forget to get your Keenvention tickets. They are available now. Presuming the world doesn't end, we will have Keenvention in 2015. Keenvention.info, and we'll see you tomorrow at freetalklive.com.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love,
and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, September 27th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.12 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,146 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports the Kurdistan Workers' Party, PKK, issued a statement on Friday claiming that multiple ambush attacks against the Turkish military has left 19 security forces dead, including 16 soldiers and 3 members of the National Police Force. These attacks were carried out over the course of the last couple of days and sparked another round of Turkish military retaliation, mostly in the form of airstrikes, with the military issuing a statement saying that 34 PKK fighters were killed in its attacks. The incidents took place along the Turkish border with Iraq. Turkey's southeast is predominantly Kurdish, and the PKK is active both there and in northern Iraq, which has also been the target of multiple airstrikes. Kurdish Member of Parliament Salma Armak reported that PKK leader Abdullah Öcalan, still in Turkish prison, has reiterated his support for a return to the 2-year ceasefire that was in place before Turkey launched airstrikes against the group late in July. Turkey has suggested that they have no intention to return to a ceasefire without a unilateral disarmament of the entire PKK and the group relocating wholly to Iraq. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Swiss authorities have banned the sale of Volkswagen diesel engine cars that may have been fitted with emission testing cheating devices. The move, seen as temporary, puts a stop to the sale of some 180,000 Volkswagen models not yet sold or registered in the country, and comes after the company was accused of using software to doctor emission testing results. Thomas Rohrbach, spokesman for the Swiss Federal Office of Roadways, said the ban was being implemented on Volkswagen vehicles with diesel engines in the Euro 5 emissions category. The ban does not apply to cars with Euro 6 engines, which are able to meet tougher emission standards set by the European Union. The move comes after the United States Environmental Protection Agency recalled 482,000 diesel-powered Volkswagens that had apparent defeat device software to allow the vehicles to cheat emissions tests. Since diesel vehicles are more popular in Europe, Volkswagen is receiving far more scrutiny there. Earlier in the week, Volkswagen chief Martin Winterkorn resigned. Matthias Mueller, the former head of Porsche, has been named the Volkswagen chief executive. Mueller said, "My most urgent task is to win back the trust of the Volkswagen group by leaving no stone unturned and with maximum transparency, as well as drawing the right conclusions from the current situation."
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports separatist parties are expected to win control of Catalonia's parliament in an election on Sunday, setting the region on course for a unilateral declaration of independence from Spain, which the central government says is impossible. Opinion polls indicate the main secessionist platform, Together for Yes, and leftist party CUP are likely to fall short of 50% of the vote, but they will still secure a majority of seats in the 135-strong regional assembly. Both have said that such a result would allow them to unilaterally declare independence within 18 months. The Spanish center-right government of Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy, which has opposed any attempt to hold a referendum on secession, has called the breakaway plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. While a breakaway by the wealthy northeastern autonomous region is still very much seen as a theoretical question, even in Catalonia, analysts say the election result will bear long-lasting consequences at local and countrywide levels. The secessionist campaign is facing a defining moment as support for the cause has steadily waned since its peak in 2013. Any failure to achieve a majority of seats would deal a serious blow to the movement. The vote may also act as a catalyst for the Spanish general election due in December. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Studies show that more and more teenagers are leaving Facebook, but where are they going instead? Apparently, to the hottest new social media site in years, the comments section of this YouTube video of a deer running in slow motion. Already, its comments section is seeing over 30 million active users. Facebook isn't giving up so easily, incorporating images and videos of deer, elk, reindeer, and even moose into their layout. But teens say that misses the point entirely. In fact, the site's one unwritten rule, don't post anything about the video itself. Teens say that's not cool. But with more and more people swapping over to the comments section of the slow motion deer video by the day, some trend watchers warn it may begin going the way of Facebook.
I was obsessed with it for a while, but now it's just boring. I'm probably gonna switch over to Happy Fast Kitchen.
While we don't know for sure, we believe Happy Fast Kitchen might refer to the Yelp page for a Chinese food restaurant in Cleveland, the new social media site where musician Skrillex recently dropped his latest album.
This is the Onion News Network.